out jamming with Juice, where it's amazingly juicy.
When Kanye said that slavery was a choice, are you hopping off that ship? Or are you saying to be a slave?
You are so funny, Juice.
Come get your drop of juice.
I wish I could just save everybody in the world who's going through something like that.
And you know you always got a friend in Ben.
Once you do pass down your wisdom to the next person, that's how you ultimately end up freeing the next generation.
From the 414 to everyone across the globe, jamming with Juice is here for you.
All the five biddies to the flow right now. See, look at that. So ignorant.
It's like a bird song.
Hey, y'all are hilarious.
No stone left unturned.
Is there a difference between hood, ratchet, and ghetto?
I don't know if this man is the devil or the Antichrist.
That was juicy. Okay, that was extremely juicy.
It's amazing.
Check out Jammin' with Juice daily on YouTube.
Skilled trade workers are the backbone of every community, and also the Army National Guard. Soldiers train to keep the power flowing, engines running, and in every other trade needed to accomplish the mission. These soldiers are on the fast track to learning skills that can set them up for success at home with companies looking to hire the best. Their resumes are being built through their paid training and part-time service. Find out how you too can learn a trade profession by visiting NationalGuard.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Damage caused by tornadoes is devastating and traumatic. After these storms, dishonest contractors show up hoping to make a quick buck from your insurance claim. They'll promise anything if they can get you to sign a contract, collect your payment in advance, and ultimately do no work at all. Avoid being the victim of contractor fraud. Get estimates from at least three contractors. Check references, and remember, if you didn't request it, reject it.
To report fraud, call us at 1-800-TELL-NICB. This is a public service message from the National Insurance Crime Bureau.
We are the home of Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
This is the Bloomberg Black Business Beat. The collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore was stunning, and we're still learning what the long-term impact might be. One aspect that could be easy to overlook is what the collapse might mean for Baltimore's local economy. That problem will need to be solved in part by two black leaders, Maryland Governor Wes Moore and Baltimore Mayor Brandon Scott. Scott talked about the potential economic ripple effect while speaking to reporters in the immediate aftermath of the collapse, citing the significance of that port to the region's workers.
It is the largest for car import and export in the country. And we have to understand the impact that that's going to have on the workers.
That audio courtesy of ABC. And with Baltimore's large black population, any disruption to the local economy will disproportionately affect black families. I'm Bloomberg's Justin Milliner on the Black Business Beat.
Imagine your team always looking and feeling their best in high-performance technical workwear. Cintas can make it happen. They have garments for almost every job imaginable. And with the Cintas Workwear program, you get freshly laundered garments delivered every week for everyone on your team. Great garments without the bother of laundry. That's a real perk for employees. Find out how Cintas can boost team image and morale. Visit Cintas.com.
Oh, I'm ready!
And get ready for the workday.
Now. Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas, loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to Now.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect that of the staff and management of Good Karma Brands, but are the sole responsibility of the host and guests of this particular show.
America may have many, many days, but they will be full of trouble. There will be no rest. There will be no tranquility in this country. Until a nation comes to terms with our problems.
Bringing you social and political commentary from his mouth to your ears. Breaking down the issues which matter to you.
You are not put here to be a white man's footstool. You are put here to represent the very best in God's word.
legendary civil rights icon, the Reverend Jesse Jackson, in the studio. Reverend Jackson, how are you?
Mr. Reverend, good morning on this chilly Milwaukee morning.
And I am pleased to have one of the founding members of the Black Panther Party, Chairman Bobby Seale. Mr. Chairman, how are you this morning?
Good morning. I'm doing just fine. Thank you.
To Mr. Eric Holder. Mr. Holder, so good to see you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine, man. How you been? It's been a long time. Haven't seen you for a while.
The Dr. Cornell West. Dr. West, how are you, sir?
My dear brother, you're so kind. You're so generous. So, man, but I salute you and the work that you were doing there. Doing a magnificent job there in Wisconsin.
Stream live on 1017thetruth.com. Call in with your questions or comments. 833-212-1017. Join us on social media at 1017thetruth. It may not be what you expect to hear, but I will definitely give you what you need to know. Are you ready for the truth?
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Sherwin Hughes.
Good morning. Welcome to the program. Today is Monday, April 8th, 2024. So there's an eclipse that's happening. And if you live in the Milwaukee area or the upper Midwest, you're going to get a pretty good view of the moon blocking the sun. It's a very big deal. Many people are becoming very unusual and very weird because there's a lot of myths and misconceptions and wives' tales surrounding the eclipse. We're going to clear those up because you people are already weird enough. And so we want to make sure that the conspiracy theorist people are not taking over the majesty of this very rare celestial occurrence. It's pretty simple. I want to make it as simple as possible because when people don't understand the details and the science behind something, they make up stuff and they get even crazier than they already are. Can we admit we don't need more crazy in the world right now? There's a lot of crazy happening. Please don't add to it. Oh, wait till you hear some of the myths surrounding the eclipse. Oh, they're so good. And some of you believe them. And even if I dispel the myths, you're still going to believe them, which is not my problem. First order of business, please don't look directly at the sun. I'm just shocked that I have to say that. Don't stare. Remember the last time we had an eclipse and they recommended you get the glasses? Don't worry, I'm going to give you locations in the Milwaukee area where you can get you some glasses. Between $1 and $3, not really sure if you can really trust some fake sunglasses that cost between $1 and $3. Personally, my eclipse glasses are made by Versace, so I'm a little bit different than most of y'all. So I'm going to give you some the locations of where you can get your $1 to $3, even some cases free, viewing glasses. But there was an eclipse some years ago when Trump was president, and the big warning was don't look directly at the sun because we know that because it's bright and it can mess up your eyeballs. And then they showed this picture of Donald Trump standing next to Melania, and he's staring directly at the sun. So don't be like Trump. We got some Trump stuff we're going to talk about today, actually. Also want to let you know that Joe Biden is going to be in Madison, Wisconsin, today talking about a newer plan to forgive some student debt. Glad the president is here talking about that. So let me decode and demystify this for you. Student debt is an issue that is troubling tens of millions of Americans. But of all of the different groups and demographics that are impacted by student debt, Black women are impacted more than anyone else. They have more debt. They pay higher interest. Their burden is heavier. So when you're talking about forgiving student debt, you are talking about a burden that falls disproportionately on Black women. The Biden administration knows this. And Black women who have tremendous amounts of student debt know this as well. And it's also no mistake that Black women have higher levels of education than African-American men. And with those higher levels of education will come increased student debt. Okay, those things go hand in hand. But because Joe Biden can't say to the country, hey, everybody, I want to forgive student debt because it's a disproportionate burden on Black women and families headed by Black women, he can't say that because the white people that have student debt will get very upset. Or the white people that have zero student debt will get even more upset, and chances are they will be against that proposal. So what they do is they look at the facts and they look at the details. Just Just like Barack Obama looked at the facts and looked at the details and said, what one thing is burdening African Americans more than anything else? Because I think Obama knew that he was going to have to do a bunch of stuff for black people, because that would be his legacy, regardless of what he did for the country, what he did for climate change, what he did for any other American policy. What he did for black people would be what his legacy is, not just with African Americans, but with everybody. So he had to look at what is the thing that was harming African Americans more than any other thing other than racism. Our lack of access to health care and affordable health care at that. Too many people were going into debt and filing bankruptcy because they had an unexpected medical emergency, and that's not fair. Too many people were not covered by health insurance companies, because if you had a pre-existing condition, they wouldn't cover you, or they'd have these lifetime maximums, et cetera. So you got to keep this in mind. The Affordable Care Act was the best thing that Barack Obama could have done for black people, but he couldn't say that because we have so much racism in this country that he would have gotten even less support for the proposal. Joe Biden is doing the exact same thing with student debt forgiveness. It is something that is going to positively impact black women, but the president can't say that. That's why I have to demystify this stuff for y'all, because as you're running around here thinking that President Biden didn't do anything for black people or black women, it's the total opposite. It's a total eclipse of your smarts. When you take away the burden of student debt, you can improve the American economy, because some of y'all would have new houses. You'd have new cars. Some of you might even get a new husband if you weren't so straddled with student debt. The other thing I'm going to say about President Biden before I get to the total eclipse of your smarts is he is the first president to put an African-American woman on the U.S. Supreme Court. He selected a black woman to be his vice presidential running mate and has selected more African-American women to assume lifetime positions on the federal bench than any of his predecessors. So you got to keep all these things in mind. Joe Biden, like it or not, believe it or not, is the president who has disproportionately benefited black women, but he can't say that because of all of the people that will get angry that he is playing favorites. He knows where his bread is buttered. He knows that when the African-American vote comes out strong, he is going to win, allowing him to do even more for underserved populations and communities. Okay, we good on that? Okay, good. Let me give you a list of where you can get your viewing glasses. Let's see here. The Horowitz D-Reamer Planetarium at the Retzer Nature Center in Waukesha. That's, I don't even know where that is. Just look it up. It's fine. The UWM Planetarium, I know where that is. That's 1900 East Kenwood Boulevard, room 139. You can get your eclipse viewing glasses from 1 until 3 p.m. Well, by 3 p.m., you would have missed the totality. At 2:08 in the p.m., right, Alex? That's when it's going to get dark outside. And this is when all the crazy people and all the conspiracy theories and all of the myths are going to come alive. Like, it's going to get dark, dark. But that's at 2:08 p.m. in Milwaukee. If you live somewhere else, it's up to you. Who cares? I don't care what time your totality is. But at 2:08 in the p.m., get your glasses, put them on your face, and look up. And it's going to get dark. The streetlights might even come on. You might even need to put on your headlights. It's going to get dark, Alex.
So do I got to get these glasses if I'm going to be driving through it?
Oh, that's a good one. Well, if you're driving, I would rather you just concentrate on driving. Because they had a thing, I was watching the Today Show this morning, and there's state troopers all over the country that are expecting an amount of traffic to be stalled. They said it's like 30 Super Bowls all letting out at once, because if people are on roads and on highways and two-lane highways, people are literally planning to stop driving and to look up. And the state troopers are like, please don't do that. Please don't stop your car on the highway. Don't do that. Get to where you need to be. Depends on where the totality is, where you live. Pull off the highway. Just go to a McDonald's parking lot. Don't stop on the highway. It's amazing how we have to tell people this, but people don't get it. I get on the freeway sometimes, depending upon where I have to go and how late I am for my meetings, I may hop on the freeway. But because I live so close to downtown, I usually can take the side streets and be downtown within 10 minutes, give or take. But on the rare occasion, I may have to hop on the highway, which I prefer not to do because I don't need to be another vehicle adding to highway congestion, because I live close enough to downtown, which is where I'm going 90% of the time, where I don't need to add, personally need to add to highway congestion. But I get on the highway, and immediately it's backed up. This is very distressing to me because I'm already late for my meeting. I jump on the highway to shave a couple of minutes off of my commute time. And you know what it is? 88.75836.4% of the time, you know what it is? There's an accident, or it's not even blocking a lane of traffic, or somebody is pulled over because, you know, that happens because in Milwaukee, people drive like they're nuts. And our increased car insurance rates are reflective of that. It's just people looking at the car that's pulled over and you're slowing down traffic. So it makes sense that these state troopers and county sheriffs all over the country have to tell people and give press conferences, don't stop driving on the freeway to look at the sun. It's amazing that we have to tell people this. The Milwaukee Public Museum will have your special glasses for $2, your eclipse viewing glasses from 12:30 until 3 p.m. Located outside the Milwaukee Public Museum by the Green Clock on Wells Street. That's 800 West Wells Street. Also, there is NASA's live webcast of the total solar eclipse. Also going to be at the Milwaukee Public Museum's Garden Gallery. You can also get your eclipse viewing glasses from the Schlitz Audubon Nature Center, 1111 East Brown Deer Road in Bayside. Today from 12:30 until 3:30 p.m. free with admission to the Schlitz Audubon Center. Okay, I'm take a break, come back, and I'm going to talk about some of the myths that are surrounding the eclipse. And some of you are going to believe these myths, especially the ones about pregnant women. I guess if a pregnant woman touches her face during the eclipse, your baby is going to have a terrible birthmark. So if you're pregnant, ladies, or men, I'm not discriminatory. Men get pregnant now. Don't touch your face because your baby will have a birthmark. So you don't want to do that. And then also, you know, the ancient people, because they didn't know what was going on. I think it was the Mayans. They thought a dragon was eating the sun. They thought very weird things. But another thing that ancient cultures would do, and I think this is in the movie Apocalypto, it's a Mel Gibson movie. They kill people. They sacrifice people during the eclipse because you got to sacrifice to the gods. And they would sacrifice virgins. None of you have that to worry about. None of you are going to have to worry about being like, oh, I'm a virgin. I'm going to get sacrificed. None of you are virgins. So some of you are having sex right now. You are listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
The baseball season is finally here, and we want to celebrate the Milwaukee Brewers with you, Truth Nation. We are excited to announce our Take Me Out to the Ball Game giveaway. From now through the end of April, we will be giving away tickets to cheer on the Brewers live from American Family Field. For your chance to win a pair of tickets to a game, you must download the 101.7 The Truth app and be on the lookout for our weekly Brewers Push notification. Play ball with The Truth and go watch The Brew Crew by downloading the 101.7 The Truth app today. For contest rules, visit 1017thetruth.com.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who, yes, you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started, wow, this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Gain skills to lead community-based organizations and develop creative solutions for social change with a bachelor's degree in community engagement and education from the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee. Created in collaboration with the community, this program provides a home for students interested in social justice. Learn alongside diverse students and supportive faculty. The program can be completed fully online, and you can earn credit for professional experience. Learn more by going to uwm.edu/CEED.
All you have is one. One chance after an accident. One decision on who to call. One shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Garage doors giving you a headache? The best way I know to deal with it is to call my friends at Geis. Family owned since 1955, Geis is the trusted authority on garage doors and openers in southeastern Wisconsin. Trust me, I use them too. Geis has doors and openers for every budget and can even build custom designs to meet your exact preferences. For fast, reliable garage repair solutions, go to geisdoors.com or call 262-784-4250.
Don't think twice. Call Geis.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
So this one comes from the Almanac, and they say, here at the Almanac, we love our folklore and mythology, and there's nothing like a total solar eclipse to get folks wondering why the sun disappeared from the sky. And I've got a listing of the most interesting stories and superstitions surrounding the eclipse, where we're going to have something like 91% totality in the Milwaukee area, which is going to get dark. And I can understand, like, the people from a long time ago, the ancient people, they're like, oh, snap, it's day, but it's night. And they'd freak out a little bit because they didn't really know science. What's sad is that now that we do know science, some of y'all are still freaking out like the ancient people. So, okay, the sun, I'm going to explain it to you as best I can in the simplest of terms. The sun is big. It's 400 times bigger than the moon. It's also 400 times further away than the moon. You understand? Sun is, it's a large, it's hot. White people love it because it makes them look like brown people. But then they're racist against the brown people, which is perplexing. So the sun is glowing. It's made out of hot helium. And it's hot, okay? And it's far. The moon, it's not as far, and it's smaller. But at that exact moment, the sun being 400 times the size of the moon and also 400 times the distance, they're going to be like pretty much the same size for a couple of minutes, and the moon is going to cover the sun. That's all it is. It happens. It's a rare event. I think the last one that happened was in the 70s, 1979. I don't remember it. I was young. The next one that's going to happen in the year 2044. And the people that saw it in 1979 are excited for today because they're doing all sorts of interviews with people. There was an interview with this one lady. She looked like a witch. And she had booked her trip to Buffalo, New York, because apparently Buffalo, New York is going to have the best eclipse viewing. And she was wearing a shirt that said something about the eclipse. Like, there's weird people coming out. Well, there's always weird people, but this is bringing out more weirdness. All right, let's see what we got here for myths. For many people in ancient times, a total solar eclipse generated fear. They thought the world would end or a great evil would follow. Remind me, I got a story about Trump. That for those of you that think that a great evil will follow, you might be credible. Myths often involve a beast trying to destroy the sun, with the fate of the earth hanging in the balance, or a sun god becoming angry, sad, or sick. Native people in Colombia shouted to the heavens, promising to work harder and mend their ways. Some worked their gardens and other projects especially hard during the eclipse to prove it. That's a good idea, even though that's the ancient Colombians. Work harder today. There's nothing wrong with working harder. In Norse culture, so those are like Norway, Finland, Sweden, those people, the gods put an evil enchanter, Loki, into chains. Loki got revenge by creating wolf-like giants, one of which swallowed the sun. Uh-oh. Swallowed the sun? Alex, did you hear that? In Norse culture, the gods put the evil enchanter Loki into chains, and Loki got revenge by creating wolf-like giants, one of which swallowed the sun, thereby causing the eclipse. Fear led the Chippewa natives to shoot flaming arrows into the sky to try to rekindle the sun. Tribes in Peru did the same for a different reason. They hoped to scare off a beast attacking the sun. Alex, you missed your cue to play Swallowed Up. Missed it. In India, the demon Rahu steals and consumes the nectar of immortality, but is beheaded before he can swallow it. What is it with all this swallowing? His immortal head flies into the heavens. The sun and the moon alerted the gods of his theft, so he takes his revenge on them. When Rahu swallows, they're swallowing again. When Rahu swallows an orb, we have an eclipse, but the orb returns to view because Rahu has nobody. That makes no sense. Similarly, in China, Mongolia, and Serbia, beheaded mythical characters chase and consume the sun and the moon, and that's why we experience the eclipse. In Indonesia and Polynesia, Rahu consumes the sun but burns his tongue, and then he spits the sun out. In Armenia, a dragon swallowed the sun and the moon. In Transylvanian folklore, an eclipse stems from the angry sun turning away and covering herself with darkness in response to men's bad behavior. Now that makes sense. The sun turns away and covers, so the sun is a woman. Which makes sense. She's hot. And then when she goes away, it gets cold. But she'll come back in the morning and she'll be hot again. The Transylvanians think that the sun is a woman, and then she turns away because of men's bad behavior. In India, many believe that when an eclipse occurs, a dragon is trying to seize the two orbs. People immerse themselves in rivers up to their neck, imploring the sun and moon to defend them against the dragon. Oh, there's more. Some cultures thought that the sun was in a fight with its lover, the moon. Others found a different kind of romantic explanation. To the Australian Aborigines, the sun was seen as a woman who carries a torch. The moon, by contrast, was regarded as a male. Because of the association of the lunar cycle with the female menstrual cycle, the moon was linked with fertility. A solar eclipse was interpreted as the moon man uniting with the sun woman. Well, that's a beautiful myth. A little bit. Alex, you missed like five opportunities to play Swallowed Up. Y'all must be having a powwow in the. Y'all talking about the eclipse in there? Get the Swallowed Up ready. I think we need to hear it. In German mythology, the hot female sun and the cold male moon were married. The sun ruled the day and the sleepy moon ruled the night. Seeking companionship, the moon was drawn to his bride. They came together, thus a solar eclipse. So it's the sun and the moon having sex, essentially.
Swallowed up. Have you ever been swallowed up?
Brian, you're on 101.7 The Truth. How are you?
Every time you play it, it is so funny. That is so freaking funny. Hey,
yes.
Sherwin.
Yes.
If the earth is spinning from, what is it, left to right?
Counterclockwise.
Counterclockwise.
Correct.
All right, so we're going at 1,000 miles an hour.
Something like that.
Okay.
moving through the moving through space at like 17,000 miles an hour. So we're moving very quickly.
Right. So why are we seeing the moon coming from the south? Shouldn't the moon be
No.
Well, they say the moon is in a different orbit, but they're showing that it's making an X across the United States. Now, my thing is, if the United States is going from right to left, okay, just like we read a book, that's the direction our Earth is going. Just like we read a book from left to right. How are we seeing an eclipse if the Earth is moving from that spot? You see what I mean?
Because the moon is also moving in unison with the Earth around the sun. So we're both orbiting the sun at the same time. And the moon rises in the east, just like the sun does, because of the Earth's rotation and the moon's position relative to Earth. Because keep in mind, the moon is rotating around the Earth the same time the moon and the Earth are rotating around the sun. So I think you just might have a little bit of misunderstanding and misconception because of your sense of direction with the moon and the sun and the rising and the east and the west.
Right. Okay. Well, that's good. I'm glad you explained that to me.
But you think the Earth is flat. So if you think the Earth is flat, technically you won't see an eclipse, Brian, because everything is flat.
Exactly. Well, you know, technically, I don't think the Earth actually moves at 1,000 miles an hour, to be honest with you.
I don't care what you think. You don't even have to believe it. It just makes you a non-believer. Okay, you know what, Brian? Have you ever been in a car going 100 miles an hour before? You have.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
And absolutely. You're in a car going 100 miles an hour, and you have a passenger next to you. And the passenger is just, they look stationary, but you're both moving at 100 miles an hour. The car is going 100 exactly. miles an hour, but because you are in the car moving 100 miles an hour, the person next to you looks like they're still. Hell, they can even be sleeping. But they're going 100 miles an hour. Same phenomenon with her. We're going very fast, but because we're all going very fast together in the same car that is the Earth, it doesn't look like nor feel like we're moving. But if you ever need evidence that we're moving, just look up. The stars change. They move. It's simple.
One other thing I wanted to ask you.
Oh, God.
Since they're going to have a total eclipse, right? How come you never see the moon leading up to going across the sun?
Because the sun is bright.
Several days when it's been bright out, and we can see the moon out right now. If the moon were out,
it depends. It depends on some things. It depends on cloud cover. It depends on what time of day. But today, the sun, especially in southeastern Wisconsin, is the moon is always out. I don't know. Do you know that? You just can't always see it because the sun is bright. Okay. The moon is always there, bro. Yes, you can't see it sometimes because the rays of the sun are brighter because the moon is not illuminated. It's only a reflection of the sun's rays that we see off the moon, but the sun is so much brighter than the moon. Sometimes you don't see the moon. That don't mean it ain't there, man.
Yeah, that's true. That's perspective. Eye perspective, probably. Okay.
Is there anything else you need from me, sir?
No, that's it.
Okay.
Hey.
Thank you. Have a great day. Bye-bye. That's Brian is our resident conspiracy theorist and flat earther, so everyone else will see the eclipse except for him because he believes that, there you go, he believes the earth is flat. He also believes that Donald Trump is the second coming of Jesus. You are listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Hey, Milwaukee, my name is Martina, and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 101.7 The Truth. Here is Melanie Ricks with her truth.
What's up, everybody? It's Melanie Ricks from Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks. A thought that I have on my mind today, you have to put out the energy that you want to receive in return. I've noticed recently that I tend to have expectations for others that I don't also have for myself. For example, if I text my friend, I expect them to respond instantly. But if somebody texts me, oh, I'll take my time and respond whenever I'm good and ready to. So why is it that I feel as if others have to get back to me right away if I'm not willing to get back to them? That's just one minor example. But when it comes to work, let's say you're feeling dissatisfied with your job performance or maybe with the atmosphere, what's going on with work, perhaps that you're hoping for a promotion of some sort and things just aren't going the way that you want. Okay, so what are you doing to fix that? What are you doing to work your way towards a better work situation? What is the energy that you are putting toward your job, toward your coworkers, even when it comes to family dynamics and other relationships or perhaps encounters with strangers? What is the energy that you are giving to the people around you? And what is the energy that you expect in return? I sincerely believe in the law of attraction, and I very much do feel that what you put out is what you will receive. So if you are someone who feels as if you are not getting the best out of things in life, perhaps it's because you are not putting your best foot forward and you are not putting the best energy that you can toward those things. The law of attraction is real, y'all. I'm telling you.
Listen to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks, weekdays from noon to 1 p.m.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Julian Johnson. The Milwaukee Bucks now dropped their fourth straight game after losing to the New York Knicks 122-109 Sunday night. The Bucks look to gain any type of momentum Tuesday in a top-seeded matchup against the number one-seeded Boston Celtics. Coverage begins at 6 on 94.5 ESPN. The Milwaukee Brewers are now 6-2 after defeating the Seattle Mariners 12-4 Sunday. They play the Cincinnati Reds Monday. Coverage begins at 5:05 on our sister station 620 WTMJ. A new champion has been crowned in the women's NCAA tournament as the University of South Carolina gets revenge and defeats Iowa 87-75. Iowa defeated them last year in the Final Four. This sports update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams, member FDIC.
It's The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
For those of you that are pregnant, and I can't say women, you're a birthing person. You can't, that's discriminatory to say a pregnant woman. It's offensive. Don't say that. You got to say a birthing person because a man, a male can be pregnant. Myth, if you are pregnant, you should not watch an eclipse because it can harm your baby. Remember, this is a myth for all of you pregnant people, birthing people, not just pregnant women. Women, stop trying to monopolize pregnancy and share it with men. You women are being racist against men because we can get pregnant too. This is related to a previous false idea that harmful radiations are emitted during a total solar eclipse, although the electromagnetic radiation from the corona, not the beer, but the sun's umbra, seen as light, is perfectly safe. There is another form of radiation that travels to the earth from the sun deep in the solar interior. I'm not reading all that. It's just pregnant people, you're fine if you watch the eclipse. Here's another myth. Eclipses will poison any food that is prepared during the event. Related to the false idea of harmful solar rays is that during a solar eclipse, some kind of radiation is produced that will harm your food. If that were the case, some radiations would harm the food in your pantry or crops in the field. The basic idea is that total solar eclipses are terrifying and their ghostly green coronae look frightening. So it is natural to want to make up fearful stories about them and look for coincidences among events around you. If someone is accidentally food poisoned with potato salad during an eclipse, some might argue that the event was related to the eclipse itself, even though hundreds of other people ate at the same location were not at all affected. Another myth. Eclipses are harbingers of something very bad about to happen. Now, this could be true. A classic case of what psychologists call confirmation bias is that we tend to remember all occasions when two things happened together, but forget all the other times when they did not. This gives us an unbiased view of causes and effects that we remember easily. Because the human brain is predisposed to look for and remembering patterns that can have been used as survival rules of thumb, total solar eclipses are not often recorded in the historical record, but they do tend to be recorded when they coincide with other historical events. For example, in 763 BC, early Assyrian records mention an eclipse in the same passage as an insurrection in the city of Asher. That was known as the Qalat Sherat in Iraq, suggesting that the ancient people linked the two in their minds. Or when King Henry I of England, the son of William the Conqueror, died in 1133 AD, the event coincided with a solar eclipse. With a little work, you can also find numerous cases where something good has happened during the eclipse. Maybe some of you will get a new job, a new promotion. Ladies, maybe some of you will actually get your period because you were worried. You're a little late. Now you're going to get it today. It'll be a very good day for you. You should go out for lunch. Another myth. There are no total eclipses at Earth's north and south poles. In fact, there is nothing especially unique about these locations from an astronomical standpoint. The last total solar eclipse viewed from the North Pole was in 2015 and passed right over the North Pole itself, in which time it came to an end exactly at the same time as the first day of spring. All right, what else we got for myths? Ah, these are all boring. Where's some weird ones? What's this one? Oh, here's an African myth. West Africans switch the gender roles of the sun and the moon and suggest that the orbs are very busy, but when they do get together, they turn off the light for privacy. A lot of these are sexual. Some Native Americans drew on similar solar eclipse concepts, saying that a solar eclipse was a visit of companions. The Tahitian myth, the orbs are lovers who join up, providing an eclipse, but get lost in the moment and created the stars to light their return to normalcy. That's pretty. That's a very nice one. Let's see what we got here. Solar eclipses and weather. It's no surprise that weather associated with an eclipse might spark some interesting theories. Let's see what we got here. The fog or dew or other precipitation resulting from an eclipse was considered dangerous and poisonous. The Japanese thought that poison would drop from the sky and they covered their water wells during an eclipse. In Transylvania doesn't even exist, does it? It's where Dracula was from, but Dracula isn't real either. Or is he? I think Transylvania is where Romania is, I think. But in Transylvania, they believe that eclipses could cause plague. I wonder if an eclipse caused coronavirus. Alaskan natives believe that the moisture and dew could cause sickness, so any moisture in the air during an eclipse will make you sick. Dishes were turned upside down and utensils were washed vigorously. Oh, here we go. This is the good stuff here. Solar eclipses and human behavior. So I'm noticing a difference in some of your behavior. I really am noticing that. It's almost like full moon on steroids, because those of us that work in this industry that interface directly with the public, mostly unfiltered, my interfacing with the public, whether it be calls, text messages, people hitting me up on Twitter, Facebook, whatever. There's a difference in people's behavior when the moon is full. Now you got to also combine Mercury being in the retrograde. Some of y'all are going insane. And I don't even know what Mercury in retrograde does besides make you want to call my exes. But I don't like any of my exes. They're all stupid. So I'm not calling none of them people. As recently as the year 2010, during the near annular very large partial eclipse, out of fear, people stayed home. Few were on the streets. Restaurants and hotels saw a dip in business. Many customers preferred not to eat at all during the event. And most schools closed when students didn't show up. And that was in 2010. In Cambodia in 1995, instead of screaming and banging during a solar eclipse, soldiers shot into the air to scare the mythic dragon from the sky. It was reported that only scattered casualties were from falling bullets. In Baja California in 1991, astronomers were surprised by the weeping and wailing of hotel staff who were terrified by the onset of darkness. No one needs to cry. It's just the moon is 400 times smaller than the sun. The moon is also 400 times closer than the sun. They're just going to get in each other's way. Your food isn't going to be poisoned. The water is safe to drink. Ladies, if you're pregnant, it's fine. It's not the sun and the moon having sex and turning out the lights, and the stars are their children. It has nothing to do with any of that. But what's crazy is some of you are going to believe these things. Even today, there are some beliefs and superstitions. Pregnant women are sometimes warned to stay inside, not eat, or not to carry sharp objects, and not to eat cooked food prior to the eclipse. Modern baby blogs ask if pregnant women should wear some sort of metal, such as a safety pin, to protect their babies. Some say that baby superstitions date from the Aztecs, who believed that a celestial beast was biting the sun and that the same thing would happen to a baby if the pregnant woman watched. Of course, none of that is true. The only health warning is do not look directly at the sun. I gave you a list of the locations in which you can get your free glasses. I'm going to put on my Versace shades and look at the eclipse because I'm going to look real cool while doing it. You're listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Here's how it works. Join DCMKE and their partner organizations and follow the employees that you find interesting. Then meet the career advocates in DCMKE's community to start forming meaningful career relationships. And lastly, scroll through your feed to find and apply to new career opportunities and get matched to openings by career advocates. Yeah, it's that easy. Access to great opportunities at the tips of your fingers. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality. That's joindcmke.com.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Learn from the experts at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee. Their faculty is recognized worldwide as leaders in their fields. As a future student, you'll get to know your professors in small classes and through hands-on learning opportunities. They also offer more than 200 programs to choose from. Plus, new freshmen are automatically considered for merit scholarships. You can receive up to $6,000 over 4 years. Find out why thousands of students are choosing UWM. Apply now at uwm.edu/admissions. That's uwm.edu/admissions.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Let's read some messages, shall we? If you want to text us, feel free. If you're doing weird things in preparation for the sun and the moon making love to each other, please let us know at 833-212-1017, 833-212-1017. Do any of you have any unusual superstitions regarding the eclipse, where we're going to have something like 91% totality here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin? It's going to get dark. So just letting you know, but not for a long time. The eclipse is here for a good time, not a long time. Let's see what we have on the YouTube. Curly Q says, good morning, Truth Nation. No meeting, so I'm here on time. I love how y'all tune into the program like you're clocking in for work. Those of you that are watching on YouTube, there is a chat stream, which is probably some of the most interesting conversation you will find anywhere on the internet. Thank you guys for checking in. Zuri Tribe says, hey, Truth Family. Felix says, good morning. Where the glasses at? Apparently, you can get the glasses at Meijer's. You know, the grocery store? There's one on 114th and Burleigh. You guys pronounce it Meijer, but I speak English. And in English, that looks like Meijer's to me. So Meijer's apparently has glasses. Creation Muse says, if you do not have glasses, view it through your front phone camera facing up. Really? All right. Don't mess your camera lens up pointing at the sun. Creation Muse says, look at your phone. Don't look at the sun. Curly Q says, for the record, I checked, and Creation Muse doesn't live in Oregon, so no cut of the jackpot for us. Oh, somebody won the Powerball? You're kidding. That was like 1.3 billion, right? Did somebody win it? Did you hear anything about that? They're very rich. I didn't play this time. I usually play when it gets over a billion, because clearly if it's less than $1 billion, it's not worth it for me. But I didn't play this time because I have a level of consistency when I play the lottery, which is extremely rare. I never win. You hear about these people, they match however many numbers. They win 100,000. There'll be several people that'll win 1 million. I've never won anything. The best part for me when I play the lottery, when it gets to $1 billion or whatever, is I plan my future after I win. Because if I won, I'd still come to work. Y'all wouldn't notice anything different about me. I wouldn't tell any of you. Now, in some states, you have to come forward and publicly claim your winnings unless you start a trust. You start a revocable trust. You got to talk to a lawyer and you get the whole thing set up. And what happens is you set up the revocable trust. You got to sign the back of the lottery ticket, but you're not signing your name. You're signing the name of the revocable trust, because technically that is who won the lottery. And then all the money goes into the revocable trust and you can invest it a whole bunch of ways. But if I won, I wouldn't tell none of y'all. Whole bunch of y'all would be like, Sherwin, remember that $7 I loaned you back in 1987? With interest, that's $11 million. Hell no, I wouldn't tell none of y'all. I'd still come to work. The only difference you might notice about me is I would take a jet to work. I would buy a plane. First thing I would do. I don't even know if I'd move right away. I would just live a modest life. I would just have a jet, a private jet with my name on it. Hughes. And it'd be red and black and have flames on it. The only thing I'd do. Let's see what else we got here. Zuri Tribe. I'm going to disagree with you, Zuri. She says, stop it. Men don't get pregnant. Yeah, they do. Yes, you can. You can identify as a man and have ovaries and a menstrual cycle and get pregnant. Don't be politically incorrect. Men, I shouldn't say men. Birthing people can get pregnant. Men or women, they thems. There's a they. Many thems are pregnant, which is fine. And they and them can get prenatal care, and I want them to have healthy babies. And be careful during the eclipse, because apparently the eclipse can harm your baby. Vanessa, we played it. She wanted to hear the swallowed up clip. We had to play it. How does the earth being flat stop an eclipse? Zuri, I don't know how that. The earth isn't flat. Because if it was, there's nothing. How is the sun and the moon round, but the earth is flat? So the earth is just a pancake. Well, if the earth is flat, how come nobody's fallen off of it yet? Okay, now I'm not even going to entertain that. We know that the earth isn't flat. Majors has glasses. Sorry, I can't confirm that. I feel like I've looked straight at the sun, so please don't look at the sun, everybody. Creation Muse says, I was born with brown eyes. Natural protection. Just kidding. Somebody's going to look at the sun. You know what? I'll probably look at it just to see. I won't stare at it. But you ever walk outside, you're in your house all day, and you just walk outside to, like, check the weather, and you just look up, and you catch a glimpse of the sun? I may catch a glimpse of it. I'm not going to stare at it, though. All right, let's see what we got here. Oh, Lord have mercy. Look who we have. Bob, if you're going to be...
I know that ain't who I think it is.
It is who I think it is. Look here, Bob. If you're going to be staring at the sun, you need to put some glasses on, man.
Man, hello, Sherwin. I am so glad you mentioned do not look at the sun, because there was someone in your radio station that said that's a lie, and I cut the radio off because, man, that's so important. It's not a lie.
Wait. Stop. Who here said that we should be looking at the sun?
I don't want to say because they do a lot for the neighborhood. Bruh. And I want to keep them. I want to keep the name private.
Tori?
Man, I'm so glad.
Is Tori or Dr. Ken? Because you said he.
No, it's not. I'm not going to say it's a he or a she, but it needs to be. They do a lot for the community. So I cannot. It's not. But I'm so glad you came out and said, do not. I was a kid. And didn't look, and I wanted to look at the sun so bad when they talk about eclipse, but I didn't. You know, it's so, I mean, how am I going to say it's a lie? And then they got tons and tons of information about don't look at the sun. Who am I going to believe? Come on. I mean, I'm so glad you came out with don't look at the sun. It's so important.
Thanks, Bob.
I mean, All right. That's all I had to say.
Okay. That's, we appreciate you.
Get off my line.
Goodbye, Bob.
Get off my line, sir.
Bob, don't play with me. Not today. Today's not the day. Don't play with me today.
Okay.
Don't do it today. He going to call me talking about get off of his line. Gene says, I hope you're being facetious about wearing regular sunglasses and looking at the eclipse. You're supposed to be smarter than that, Mr. Hughes. I'm not as smart as you think. Trust me. I just play smart on the radio. The Truth with Sherwin Hughes will be back for hour two.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Gruber Law Offices, and The Truth have raised the stakes for this year. The One Call, That's All Gruber Cash Giveaway is now a 5K giveaway. Yes, you heard it right. $5,000 giveaway. Every weekday on 101.7 The Truth, you will have the chance to be entered to win the 5K giveaway. Listen to The Truth for the One Call, That's All cue to call for your chance to win $5,000. Gruber Law Offices, One Call, That's All. Visit 1017thetruth.com for official contest rules.
1017 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to five Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on The Truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
Look at how Black powerful people are covered in the media and portrayed. We're not talking about their innocence or guilt. We're talking about how it is handled. It is an attempt to continue to perpetuate the stereotype that Black powerful wealthy people can only be Black powerful wealthy people based on their criminal activities. And that is not consistent with other races or genders.
You're so right when you look at a lot of the people that have risen to prominence with Bishop T.D. Jakes, man of the cloth. After you reach a certain point and it's, he's this or he's doing that and tied him to Diddy. And the thing is, that is the common theme. And this goes back to the 60s. It goes back to Dr. King and Malcolm X and being on the FBI most wanted list.
Tune in to all your favorite 101.7 The Truth shows all day, every day by downloading the Truth app.
One smile is great, but one smile in a community of smiles is so much better. A smile has a secret power that most people don't know about. A smile multiplies. It spreads from one person to the next, stretching across entire groups of people. Smile Train knows this and is proud to be creating a wave of smiles across the cleft lip and palate community in over 70 countries. Patients, doctors, advocates, fundraisers. Collectively, our smiles are a celebration of the transformed lives of over 1.5 million children. Learn how Smile Train is helping the cleft lip and palate community at smiletrain.org/learn. Smile Train, changing the world one smile at a time.
Truth Nation, stand up and tap in. This is 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
It's The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Welcome to Hour 2 of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes. So the first hour I had to talk about the eclipse and making sure that people are safe. You're not staring directly at the sun. I listed a couple of locations where you can, in the southeastern Wisconsin area, Milwaukee specifically, where you can get your glasses. I know a lot of you watched the Women's National Basketball Championship. I watched it too. I don't usually watch women's basketball because, well, not a lot of you do, but now all of a sudden I got to be a fan. Shout out to the South Carolina women. Can I just read you the headline, though, from a mainstream media outlet? The South Carolina Gamecocks beat off a challenge from Iowa.
What do you mean by that?
That's what it said. It's very ironic that the mascot is the Gamecock, and the Gamecocks beat off Iowa, the challenge from Iowa, so the Gamecocks did the beating off of the challenge.
Damn!
The unbeaten South Carolina Gamecocks defeated Iowa on Sunday 87-75 in the NCAA Women's Championship, The Gamecocks' win ended Caitlin Clark's final game in Iowa. I don't understand what the hype was with that woman, Caitlin Clark. She's getting a little too big for her britches, wasn't she? I thought she was getting a little too big. I could dunk on her. I think I could. I think I could beat her. I'm sorry, guys. You can say all you want about me, but I could beat some of them. You see the way some of them shoot? So women's basketball is more fundamental and it's more technical because it has to be. Because even the ones that are really tall, there's no dunking. There's very little dunking. There's very little alley-ooping. It's just not the same. Speaking of someone who's not the same. Linda, get a hold of yourself, woman.
Good morning. Good morning, Professor. Good morning, good common brand. And good morning to all the good black and white people of Milwaukee. I send you love and light and peace. Oh, my God. This is so funny, Sherwin. You're so funny. I decided to just hang in the house and lay in the bed, lounge around, because, you know, I just want to watch everybody else act a fool. And just reading the YouTube comments that you just went through, I was reading it before you went through it. I was rolling. Oh, my God, Zuri and Curly. Oh, my God. It's just so funny. It's like reading comments off TikTok.
Oh, it's worse. This is worse than any TikTok comment thread. These people are insane. I mean, I love all of them, I think the eclipse is messing with people's heads.
I love them all. And then just you going through that, I didn't know. It's like, oh, my God, just how people, human behavior is just so, oh, my God. It's just so funny at times, so amazing, so incredible. And all the, you know, stories and the myths, and it's just crazy. This whole country's world is like crazy. We are in a war. We got another potential war about to happen. And
what war is that? We ain't at war, Lynn. Ain't nobody at. There's no war going on. I mean, there's one going on in the Middle East.
Well, I think the tension between America and Israel, Netanyahu and Biden, is really something to be concerned about, though. You know, because Netanyahu, he just psycho. He crazy. For real. He don't have no compassion for people. And I'm just real concerned about our relationship with them, because he don't feel like he's wrong. He's a self-righteous, arrogant narcissist. And he just know America's going to come through. So, like, he continues to bomb these people. So, yeah, that concerns me while we are over here, you know, tripping about a natural phenomenon. You know, I mean, it's natural.
It is natural. You're right. I don't really talk much about the conflict going on in Israel because I don't want someone to mistake my words for being anti-Semitic. I just know what Benjamin Netanyahu and his military is doing to the Palestinian people would be a blueprint for what white America would do to black people. They would cut off our electricity. They would stop food supplies. They would bomb our hospitals. That would be the playbook. If you want to exterminate a minority group in your land, in your country, to just get rid of them, they are doing an expert job at that. So black folks need to pay a lot of attention, because we are the Palestinians, especially in Milwaukee. And the north side is the Gaza Strip.
Well, so it's Sudan, Congo. It's already going on before that war even started. They've been murdering. I mean, Rwanda just had a 30-year anniversary of the genocide that went on there. So it appalls me that we can give this much attention to Palestine, which I do have compassion for. But I'm just saying, look, they're looking over Africa, which has been going on for how many years now? So it just amazes me, human behavior. You know, you can welcome Ukrainians on one end of America, but you stop the Haitians and the Mexicans on the other end of America. I don't get it, but hey, I just live in the country. I don't run it.
Fair enough.
I just want to say on a lighter note that I'm very touched and I'm happy to wake up to Sherwin Hughes' views and good news and love and all of that to black and white Milwaukee, you know.
Why you keep forgetting all the other people, Linda? You always just talk about the black and the white. It's others. There's Asians.
Yes, I'm saying, yeah, and all of them, because you know what? I don't mean to disrespect anyone, because I know that we're all at a level of our own that we're, you know, facing, experiencing, and challenging, especially in an oppressive country that, you know, we all know has, we live in two different Americas. So I'm just talking to all of us who are, you know, good-hearted people.
That's wonderful. Linda, a question before you go. Do you feel oppressed as a woman?
Absolutely.
Really? Who's oppressing you?
And I want to say too that before you go on to that, I want to say too that I will never say a birthing person. That's for the law to say because of all the spectrum that it governs.
Don't be rude.
As far as me and my personal belief, I will always say a pregnant woman, because only a natural woman can be pregnant.
You're being racist.
Now, what else you wanted to say?
I was going to ask you, who is oppressing you specifically? I'm not saying that you're not oppressed, but like who is the oppressor?
I would have to say, first and foremost, I am oppressing myself, because I have to heal myself. Because when you're not healed, you oppress yourself. You're like you're in a cage with the door open. So I am the first oppressor.
I don't think you should be so hard on yourself, Linda, because we've all gone through things and you've clearly gone through things. And we think that healing is like the end result. There is no healing. You just learn to live with and how to function with the things that may have happened to you. So I don't want people to think like, oh, I need to heal, because no one ever gets healed. You just find a way to live with the trauma. So you got to find a way to live with it instead of thinking that you're going to be healed. Because if you're never healed, you're never going to forgive yourself.
But I'd like to respectfully disagree, Sherwin, because in my own research in the last 7 years in that regard, I'd like to say that healing is freeing. And in my healing, I am free, and I'm free enough to communicate, you know, my trauma. And that's when you know you've healed, because you are able to get through the effects of that trauma, which can be low self-esteem, insecurity, lack of trust in others. It could be the lack of believing in yourself, loving yourself, knowing how to love yourself, seeing the beauty in yourself. All of those are effects of trauma.
Have you tried forgiveness? Because that can be healing and freeing too.
Yes.
And you forgive, not to excuse them. The forgiveness allows you to be able to move on and to move forward. But here's the other thing I want to ask. Have you ever been in a situation or talked to somebody that reminds you of a traumatic experience, or it feels very similar to something you had been through before, and you react like viscerally, like you still may get triggered by certain things?
Yes.
Okay. The triggers are always going to be there. They're always going to be there.
Yes, and that's the universe's way of showing you if you have healed and if you are still, you know, triggered by your...
You're always going to be triggered. Here's what healing is, Lyndon. I don't want to yell at you. I need you to listen. Maybe you need to listen.
That will happen.
You'll always be triggered, but healing is, because everybody in the world doesn't know your triggers. And somebody could be talking to you and they could trigger something, a thought, a feeling, or an emotion that takes you right back to the trauma. Healing is knowing that other people don't know your triggers, so we can't get mad at them when they trigger us, because it's not their responsibility to know our triggers.
Yes, okay. That is the awareness of your healing process. Yes, and I want to say to everyone, if you are here, you are the superhero of your story.
There you go.
If you're still here and you're still living, you're the superhero of your story.
Amen. All right.
Bye-bye.
Happy healing, Linda. I hope you heal very well.
Dion said, Caitlin Clark is a trans male. First of all, it would be trans female. And that wrong. That's not true. LT said that Linda's a racist.
Damn.
Gene says, Liz Brown said that you don't need special glasses to look at the eclipse, and it's good for you. It recharges your sun crap. Okay, so Liz going to come tomorrow and be blind. She going to come with some Ray Charles glasses and a stick. I looked at the sun. Now I can't drive no more. She didn't really say that, did she? Don't look at the sun. Like, isn't that common sense? Even though it's going to get dark, you're still not supposed to look at it. Gene yelled at me because I want to be stylish when I view the eclipse. And my sunglasses are very dark. But apparently I need to get the special ones. I'm going to the Milwaukee Public Museum after the show because apparently they've got the free glasses. All right. Sonny says that was Liz Brown. Oh, so that's what Gene was saying. Liz was telling people to look at the sun. It'll recharge you. Well, Liz, I hope you enjoy your sight while you have it, because she can be like, damn, now I got to learn Braille. Braille's got to be hard to learn when you think about it.
Is there like a certain amount of time if you just stare and look at it, then you go blind, or is it like a whole minute, or is it like literally like 30 seconds or 5 minutes?
Why would you take that chance?
I was just curious.
Because you don't want to be blind. Like, anything that can threaten my eyesight, because I use my eyes every day. It's how I know I'm awake.
Well, I'm going to be driving through it, so if I like look up at the sun for like 10 seconds, am I going to go blind?
Well, I'd rather you not. Do you normally look at the sun?
It's a big sun.
Put your visor down, Alex. Don't look at the sun. You have sunglasses? I'm sure you do, because you don't have sunglasses. You do not
like them.
Why not?
I don't know. Just never like sunglasses. Took me a while to like hats too, but now I like hats.
I'm thinking I should go get my sunglasses out the car, but I don't know if I can make it back in time because our commercial breaks are short. I should go get my sunglasses. Brittany says, what law firm would you hire for your trust if you won the lottery? Brittany, I'll worry about that when I win the lottery. And if I did win the lottery, I'm not telling you anything. Y'all ain't gonna notice anything different about me. Maybe a slightly larger diamond in my ear. Maybe a different watch. A private jet parked at the Signature Airport. You know, we have an airport for private jets here in Milwaukee. I've flown private before. Nothing like it. There's nothing like it. I can't even explain. I don't even have words, and I use words for a living. There's nothing like it. So the first thing I'm going to do, some of y'all, if you win the lottery, and apparently somebody won the lottery. They won the Powerball of 1.something billion dollars. Some of y'all, oh, I'm going to buy a car. Oh, I'm going to buy a house. Yeah, eventually I would get myself a sprawling estate in a community called Summerlin. It is just outside of Las Vegas, so I'd give me, I don't know, something reasonable, 4,500, 5,000 square foot house in Summerlin. But I would get a plane and a pilot and a bunch of flight attendants. And I would just live my best life and just fly places. Like, I would, so I'd do my radio show, okay? And I would actually be here in the studio, not all that cheating stuff where people broadcast remotely. That ain't radio. That's a cell phone call. So I would do the show, and then I would hop on my jet, and I would fly to, like, Palm Springs for lunch. And I'd have a couple martinis, and I'd get back on the plane and come back to Milwaukee in time for dinner here at my favorite restaurants in Milwaukee. I wouldn't change all that much, I don't think. Maybe I would buy, like, a new set of neckties, probably. Buy some different shoes, maybe. I don't know. That's probably about it. But y'all wouldn't notice much. Because if y'all started noticing that I was a billionaire, a bunch of y'all would just start coming out of the woodwork. I'd have a whole bunch of family members I didn't know about. Everybody would have hard luck stories.
MPS would hit me up for a couple hundred million. Hi, Sherwin. Hi. Hi, we need it for the babies.
You know what MPS might be doing with our money? What if they have the teachers and administrators have sex parties? Do y'all know how freaky public school teachers are? Only rivaled by nurses. Like, they do some very strange things.
Swallowed up. Have you ever been swallowed up?
You're listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
April is Financial Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered when learning about how you can best manage your finances. Tune in all month long as a representative from Educators Credit Union will be joining us to discuss financial strategies and tools they offer members to help enhance your financial management skills. Dig deep and spring clean your finances by joining us for Financial Literacy Month. Financial Literacy Month on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by Educators Credit Union. Achieving more together.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Here's how it works. Join DCMKE and their partner organizations and follow the employees that you find interesting. Then meet the career advocates in DCMKE's community to start forming meaningful career relationships. And lastly, scroll through your feed to find and apply to new career opportunities and get matched to openings by career advocates. Yeah, it's that easy. Access to great opportunities at the tips of your fingers. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality. That's joindcmke.com.
Happy Financial Literacy Month from Educators Credit Union. If you're dreaming of financial freedom, new ways to pay down debt, or tips to invest in your future, Educators Credit Union can help. They offer budgeting tools, personal finance courses, and debt solutions to turn your financial dreams into reality. Learn more at ecu.com. That is ecu.com. Membership at Educators Credit Union is open to anyone who lives or works in southeastern Wisconsin, and they are federally insured by NCUA.
At Grunberg Law Offices, we take great pride in helping those who have trusted us after a serious accident. Our team has the knowledge, resources, and experience to get you the results you deserve. Don't wait to get the help you need. Make the right call. Call Grunberg Law Offices today. Proud partner of your Milwaukee Bucks. One call, that's all.
We Energies want you to keep this important safety message in mind. Before you start digging, planting, or landscaping on your property, call 811 to have underground utilities marked. Calling 811 at least 3 business days before you plan to dig will help you know what's below and can prevent a hazardous situation. Our representatives will mark the underground utilities on your property for free. So remember, stay safe and call before you dig.
We Energies, people you can trust, energy you can depend on.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
LT says Gabby Marshall is gorgeous. Caitlin Clark is not transgender. That's what all weak white men say about black women. I'm going to get my eclipse glasses now. LT says you may not go blind, but studies show your vision can be damaged severely for 3 to 6 months. Travis says, I'm just saying Liz Brown could be right. What is the percentage of people going blind looking at the eclipse? I don't even know why this is a conversation. What else we have here? All right, guys, I told you all I can tell you. I told you where you can get your eclipse glasses. If you rewind this program on YouTube to the beginning, I talk about the locations in Milwaukee County where you can get your eclipse glasses. I was warned I can't use my very expensive and very beautiful Versace sunglasses to stare at the sun. I think I can, but I'm not going to, because if I show up here tomorrow blind, ooh, y'all wouldn't stop laughing at me. I walk in with a cane and a dog and a helper, because you need a helper. I don't know how I would get here. I'd have to take an Uber. I can't even use my cell phone. How do you use your cell phone if you can't see? You got to put it on talking mode to where it says all the stuff that's on the screen. How do blind people use Uber? Does Uber have a phone number where you can call and be like, hey, here's the address I'm at, here's where I need to go, and then they can call your Uber that way? Some of y'all are going to be blind tomorrow, so enjoy seeing while you can. And those of you that go blind tomorrow, it'll be the best your spouse has ever looked. I'm kidding. I'm just joking around. All right, let's see what we got here with the Powerball winner. Do they come forward yet? A Powerball ticket sold in Oregon has won the nearly $1.33 billion jackpot, the fourth largest jackpot in the history of the game. Saturday's winning numbers are, not that it matters, because none of you won. Hey, Oregon Powerball winner, I think they're in Portland. I think that's what the story says. The ticket was sold in Portland. If you happen to be listening to this program, which you probably are, because why wouldn't you be? Why don't you break your boy off a little slice of pie? Just a little bit. Just let me tell you what. I don't even need all that much money. You give me, I won't even ask for a million. Let me get $730,000. If I got $730,000, I would be able to invest that, turn it around, flip it. I could live real comfortable. I mean, I can't get a private jet with it, but I don't even need a full million. The winning numbers are 44, 27, 52, 22, 69, and the Powerball was 9. A single ticket sold in Oregon matched all six numbers drawn to win the grand prize worth $1,326 million. The lucky ticket holder will have the choice between an annuitized prize or a lump sum payment of, oh my God, oh, $621 million. Both before taxes, according to Powerball. So I wouldn't take the annuity, because what if you died? Because the annuity is you get like 50 equal payments once a year or something like that. But if you only live 4 years, then you're leaving a whole bunch of money on the table. So I would want the lump sum. And I would just give a lot of money away, because being a millionaire is probably lonely. Because if all your friends aren't millionaires, then who are you going to do stuff with? Unless you meet other millionaires. Final ticket sales pushed the jackpot beyond its earlier estimate of $1.3 billion. Now the eighth largest among U.S. lottery jackpot games, Powerball said in a news release. Others also won big this weekend. Seven tickets matched all five white balls to win million-dollar prizes in Arizona, Delaware, Florida, Iowa, Massachusetts, Michigan, and Wyoming. So nothing in Wisconsin. Saturday's drawing was scheduled to take place at 10:59 Eastern time, but was delayed for more than 3 hours. Powerball said one lottery needed additional time to complete the required pre-draw procedures before the drawing could take place. This has been one of the game's longest streaks, according to Powerball. The jackpot was previously won on New Year's Day when a ticket in the state of Michigan scored $842,400,000. The largest Powerball jackpot and the largest U.S. lottery prize ever won was $2.04 billion by a single ticket purchased in California in November of 2022, and that's according to the lottery. Ranking second and third are $1.765 billion and $1.586 billion, and those were three tickets that were sold in 2016. Winning the Powerball jackpot means a ticket matched all five white balls plus the red Powerball. The odds of winning any prize in a Powerball drawing are 1 in 24.9, and the odds of winning the jackpot are 1 in 292.2 million, and that's according to the lottery. Tickets cost $2 and are sold in 45 states, the District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, the U.S. Virgin Islands as well. Drawings are held Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays at 10:59 p.m. Eastern Time in Tallahassee, Florida. All right, let's see what we got here. Dion says, Sherwin, I shared something in Hughes' views about America, how America adopted the Nazi ideology. We have. We've adopted a lot of stuff. The convention center in Huntsville, Alabama is called the Von Braun Center, named after Maximilian Werner von Braun. He was a Nazi. We imported a lot of Nazis after World War II because they were good at science, and we used the Nazis, and we gave them citizenship. There's even some Nazis that came over here and got Social Security. Did y'all know that? Barack Obama found, when he got, became president, when Barack Obama found out there were still Nazis that we imported here. Talk about immigrants. Of all the immigrants you let into America, why them? But when Barack Obama found out in 2010 that there were still Nazis receiving Social Security, he stopped it. He was like, you can't get Social Security anymore. You're a Nazi. But no, we, in fact, so Henry Ford was as anti-Semitic as Adolf Hitler. In fact, like, did y'all know that Henry Ford, our friend, and Adolf Hitler were friends? Like, Ford sent Hitler something for his birthday, and then Hitler had, like, a picture of Henry Ford, like, on his desk. Like, they were close. And Henry Ford used to have, like, these classes he would make his employees go through that would Americanize people. He was very, very anti-Semitic. In fact, oh, it's probably been 15 or 20 years ago now, there was an unedited showing of the movie Schindler's List. Very good movie if you haven't seen it. It's very long, though. Very long. So it was unedited and uninterrupted by commercials that was put on by the Ford Motor Company. They have, like, a foundation. And they sponsored a showing of the movie Schindler's List to try and make up for Henry Ford's notorious Nazi past. There were also American companies that were involved in the extermination effort of Jews from Eastern and Western Europe, including IBM made machines that help count and tabulate the number of Jews that lived in certain places. Oh, American, corporate America was very heavily involved with Nazi Germany. So the fact that there are things that are synonymous with Nazi Germany and America does not shock anybody. In Germany, you can't even fly a Nazi flag. It's a felony. They don't like that because the Germans, they feel, some of them feel bad. We feel terrible about what we did a long time ago. We do not want to be reminded of it. But they also, they paid reparations, didn't they? But then they also did something that maybe my perspective is different than that of the mainstream. They said, hey, Jews in Europe, we know you had a really rough go, and this was very terrible what the Nazis did to you. So we're going to expel you from Europe and give you your own country. Isn't that still expelling the Jews from Europe when you tell them all to go to Israel? And the Palestinians were like, hey, we live here. And the Jews were like, yeah, but we were told that we're going to live here too. So you expel, I shouldn't say expel. You offer the Jewish people and the diaspora of the Jewish people, even if you're an American Jew, you can go over to Israel and just like get a house. Even if it's a Palestinian family living in it, because that's the part that they don't tell us. Like, there have been situations, you can go look all this stuff up when you guys are doing your quote-unquote research. A Palestinian family will go out to lunch, come home, and a Jewish family will be in their house. And the Palestinian family, you're homeless. There's nothing they can do. Oh, it's very bad. It's terrible. What else we got here? Dion says they're lying. Ain't nobody won that much money. Don't you believe that? Well, I believe this, Dion. I bet you, with your lunch lady being ass, you ain't won that money. For those of you that don't know, Dion is a lunch lady, even though he's a man. He's bald. He wears a hairnet. He sweats a lot. And he always wants to hug people. He always is sweating. And he sometimes wears his hairnet like some women just wear bonnets. He just wears it. But Deanna, I believe that people actually won. Someone won the Powerball. And whoever they are, good luck to them. I wish them nothing but good fortune. Right now, I'm going to take a break. You are listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes, and we do this Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. until 12 noon Central Standard Time. If you haven't done so already, by all means, download the free 1017 The Truth app, where you can stream this program and all the programs across our lineup. If you missed the show, the podcasts are available there. And also, from time to time, we'll do giveaways that you can only win because you have the Truth app downloaded. And thank you to everyone who is joining us live on YouTube. Go to YouTube.com or open up your YouTube app on your smartphone or other mobile device. Search 1017 The Truth, and you can see what we're doing because there's cameras in the studio. The Truth with Sherwin Hughes will be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
It's early in the year and we're trying to hit these fitness goals. 0 to 100 Fitness is dedicated to the Milwaukee community, offering affordable and quality fitness and mixed martial arts programs for the last 10 years. They have competitive and novice classes in MMA, kickboxing, and grappling for all skill levels and ages. From youth, community outreach, women's self-defense, and personal safety programs, 0 to 100 Fitness will help you on your journey to greatness. So get up off the couch and into the best shape of your life. Call 414-522-1275 today.
It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 1017 The Truth. Here is Telly Hughes with his truth.
How many times have we been told perception is reality? Look, I'm not here to dispute that, but as true as that statement is, it couldn't be further from the truth when it comes to social media. The way we perceive something or somebody on social media is typically nowhere near how things are in their real lives. Unfortunately, identifying the difference between people's online life versus their real lives gets compromised because people want it to be real. And that's okay. What's not okay is people trying to live up to these fictitious lives that's being presented and getting thousands of likes. You often see posts of people on vacation with the caption, "Living my best life," or "So-and-so doesn't owe me anything." Again, nothing wrong with that. But I wish people would view social media like they do SportsCenter. On those type of sports shows, they only show the highlights of the game. Highlights. On social media, you're only seeing the highlights of people's lives because you probably won't get many likes on a post that shows you stressing over having more bills than money and trying to figure it out. The point is, don't get caught up trying to live up to something that isn't even real. Influencers are going to influence, and some have made a hefty living doing so. But happiness isn't a one-size-fit-all contraption. Create your own happiness. Plan out how you're going to obtain it, and then protect it the same way you would guard your most prized possession.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 1017 The Truth. Listen to The Truth Be Told with DT and Telly weekdays from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m.
It's The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Before the Waupaca County Republicans sat down for their Lincoln-Reagan-Trump dinner last month, they bowed their heads for a prayer centered squarely on November. A local pastor began by saying, quote, "We pray for these upcoming elections and asking God to be with every ballot box or be with every voting station." He hoped young people would see that America needs their votes. Not long after, local conservative radio host Joe Giganti stood before the crowd of about 200 people and invoked God once more, and he was more direct. This isn't really a battle of Republican versus Democrat. It's not even a battle of conservative versus liberal. It's a battle between good and evil, God and the devil, Giganti said to his fans who were cheering and whistling. We must choose God. I'm going to be very objective here. I'm going to do my darndest not to show any bias, which is very tough for me. I'm learning every day to be less biased in some things. I'm very opinionated. You all know that. I editorialize a lot of things. Like, you may read an article, or I'll post an article in the Hughes Views Facebook group, and then I'll give my opinion on it. From my perspective, from my viewpoint, via my experience, etc. That's how I editorialize things. But I'm going to try my darndest not to editorialize this. But how? And I want you to explain it to me like I'm a child, because I don't understand it, and I want to be able to understand it. How did Donald Trump become synonymous with both God, good, and Jesus Christ? How? Fairly recently, I looked up the definition for the Antichrist. And what I read could have been an explicit definition of who Donald Trump is. And so those who are the faithful, you know, we've had many conversations about religion on this program and how different cultures and nationalities interact with religion. And I'm not ready to dig those bones up today. I don't want to talk to you about religion. It is what it is. I respect and protect your right to worship whatever, whoever, whenever you want to. I'm all for it. Whatever makes you a great person, whatever gives you faith, whatever gives you hope, whatever makes you more respectful to your fellow human being, I'm totally in support of that. I don't care what you celebrate or what gods you have, but how did the Christian faithful in this country, I'm talking about the deep evangelicals that believe that Jesus is actually coming today because of the eclipse, how did they find an affection, like a doting affection for Donald Trump? I cannot understand it. What am I missing? And if there is a formula to a man that cheats on his many wives and then pays porn stars and then pays the porn stars again to not talk about the sex he had with the porn stars, how does that man become synonymous with the Most High?
I love the poorly educated.
Of course he does. He has to love the poorly educated. And if there's a formula where how you can be the biggest, most evil sinner, because, okay, for those of you that are parents that are raising children, God bless you. I know you remember your life before you have kids. I know you remember. It was different. Would you tell your children that Donald Trump is an example for them to aspire to? And I'm not talking about the business stuff, because first of all, he doesn't even have as much money as he said he had in the first place. Is he an example of who you want your sons to be like? I mean, like every part of Donald Trump. The lying, the cheating, the bigotry, the womanizing, the grabbing by the hoo-ha of being responsible or claiming responsibility for taking away a woman's fundamental health care right. Ladies that are raising sons or women that are raising men, is Donald Trump an example of who you want your son to be like? Women that are raising girls, do you want your little girl or your adult unmarried daughter or granddaughter to marry a man like Donald Trump? Is the money he purportedly has, is that enough to overlook how horrible, how drastically horrible of a human being he is? How he led vulnerable people to think that an election got stolen? Newsflash, nobody steals an election in America. That's not the kind of crime we commit. Nobody is interested in that. And let me also say this for those of you that believe that the election was stolen. If we were going to steal an election, we would have stole it for Obama, because we didn't have to steal the election for the black guy. We don't ever want to have to steal an election, because if somebody's going to steal an election, it's going to be black people saying, yeah, we need a black president to fix some of this black stuff. But we didn't have to steal it because white people loved Obama. They still do. In fact, they use Obama as the reason why they're not racist. Well, sure, when I voted for Obama. Yeah, but you're wearing a Confederate flag. Oh, that's just my attire for the day. How did Donald Trump become so ingratiated by the evangelical faithful that now this election is not versus Democrat versus Republican or liberal versus conservative? It's none of that. It's not helping the people versus helping rich people and helping businesses. It's about good versus evil and God versus the devil. How did that happen? And if there's a formula for making that happen, I think we need to study it, because if evangelicals can be so incredibly mesmerized, hypnotized, and fully and thoroughly indoctrinated by Donald Trump, then it can happen again. And it can happen to you. I liken the man to Jim Jones. Are you guys familiar with Jim Jones, the cult leader that took a whole bunch of people down to South Africa, not South Africa, South America, the People's Temple? I saw a documentary on exactly how that happened, because I'm fascinated by cults. Another one was David Koresh and the Branch Davidians. That's another cult. I'm fascinated how large groups of people can become so, and there's been so many cults throughout history, but how mass groups of people can be involved in this concept called groupthink, which is not unusual. Groupthink is basically the beliefs of a society, but how they can be so extreme and so far away from what's normal. It's just fascinating to me. And they always liken the leader of this cult to something Masonic, something godlike, the second coming of Jesus. David Koresh did that. And it always starts with a religion and a fundamentalist view and certain interpretations of the Bible that leads good, honest, usually decent people into believing this person is the second coming. And then they end up like killing themselves. I cannot understand it. Like, I've been a fan of someone, but not, I think I want to worship them. I think I want to live in a compound with them. I just don't understand how it can happen. And I've been trying to understand it. But when I saw this documentary on the People's Temple, it was in the late 1970s, when Jim Jones took a bunch of people. And it was very diverse. It was black people and white people and all the people that Linda says hello to every day. And there's some Asians. I don't want to forget about the Asians. We like the Asians. And other people. What else is there? Latinos. I got a story about the Latinos. I don't think the Latinos and the black people get along so good. I don't know. We don't work together. Well, the Puerto Ricans like us very much. The Puerto Ricans are like black people that can swim and speak Spanish. Like those, we love the Puerto Ricans. The Puerto Ricans will tell you in a second, you know, I'm black. They just don't look like it, but I'm telling you. You know, we used to be with the slaves. I know Puerto Ricans, because they don't deny their black heritage. But other Latinos, they, I probably shouldn't bring that story up because it may sow racial divisions. Let me stay on topic. How does the cultism happen? Like, I like Barack Obama a lot, but if Barack Obama said, oh, sure, when you want to move to a compound with me and Michelle and the kids and just live with a whole bunch of people, I'd be like, no, I don't want, no. You can't watch any television. The only books you can read are the ones that I wrote. I'm going to give you the Barack Obama version of the Bible. I would think Barack Obama was nuts. I'm like, dude, I'll vote for you, but I'm not going to move in and be one of your concubines. Because that's the other thing about these cults. There's always sex. There's always a lot of sex, and they're sexing each other. And then the cult leader will have like 32 wives. And a man who's married to his wife, and the husband and the wife will join the cult. And then the cult leader will be like, hey, let me get your wife for a little while. And the husband will be like, all right, Mr. Cult Man, here you go. And then he whisks the wife away on a cloud of smoke, and her hair is blowing in the wind, and poof, her clothes come off. And then they... I don't understand how that happens. I'm not married, but if I was, I don't want the cult man sleeping with my wife, because what if he does a better job than me?
Damn.
So I'm going to check the text messages, and I'm hoping that there is an answer to how someone can be so mesmerized by a cult. Is it just like vulnerable people and they have no hope and they have nothing to look forward to? And then a person comes along and says, oh, if you come with me, your dreams will come true and I'll make the world better for you and you'll be happy and you'll live in bliss and there'll be no more misery. I just don't understand it. especially when there are people here, right here in Wisconsin. Even before the eclipse made you guys go nuts and before Mercury being in retrograde, even before that, there were people that are calling Donald Trump the second coming. If you have any answers for me, please, by all means, 833-212-1017, 833-212-1017. You're listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
What's good, y'all? This is 1017 The Truth, Telly Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. The goal of Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is to provide a platform for citizens of Milwaukee and Truth Nation to have their voices heard about concerns that have daily direct impact. So join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the award-winning 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
This is Community Heartbeat, presented by Outreach Community Health Centers on 1017 The Truth.
There are individuals in our community who certainly need health services, a variety of health services. What if they do not have health insurance? How can you serve that population?
Our community health center allows patients to come to our clinic regardless of their ability to pay, and that's part of our federal funding. You can come to our clinic and be seen based on what we call a poverty level. So anyone 200% or below a poverty level can be seen in our clinic for anywhere from $20 to $40 for that visit. So in other words, if your visit is a $400 visit and you fall on our sliding scale where you pay $20 for your visit, you would not be responsible for the $400. You'd only be responsible for $20 for that visit. Also, our pharmacy prescriptions are very, very affordable as well. Where you would normally pay, let's say for an inhaler, $240 a month for an inhaler, at our facility that would cost you about $4 or $5.
It's very good to know you guys have a sliding scale that makes it very, very affordable.
Hey Milwaukee, my name is Martina and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
Happy Financial Literacy Month from Educators Credit Union. If you're dreaming of financial freedom, new ways to pay down debt, or tips to invest in your future, Educators Credit Union can help. They offer budgeting tools, personal finance courses, and debt solutions to turn your financial dreams into reality. Learn more at ecu.com. That is ecu.com. Membership at Educators Credit Union is open to anyone who lives or works in southeastern Wisconsin, and they are federally insured by NCUA.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Brian, of all people, said, his words, not mine. Okay? I can quote somebody saying something that's politically incorrect. Those are not my words. Just like, well, maybe not. Black people, is it okay if a white person says the N-word if they're quoting somebody else? Like Tupac. Do you allow your white friends to use the N-word around you? Anyways, Brian says, how ironic is this? There are just a lot of retarded, mentally hurt persons out there then and now. Huh. It's funny that you should mention that, Brian. It's very interesting. I'm trying to figure out how an American, because aren't we free thinkers? We're independent thinkers. We're critical thinkers. we have to be mindful of a demagogue coming and trying to enchant the American body politic. We choose our leaders. Our leaders don't choose us. We need to be skeptical of people that have great wealth and great power. Like, that is indoctrinated into all of us. It's why we don't have kings here. But a lot of y'all are really into the royal family. Apparently, they all have cancer. You guys hear about that? Both Prince Charles and that lady, Kate Middleton, they got cancer. And cancer is not good. Cancer is very bad. But when you consider the crimes of the royal family throughout the centuries, don't just look at this incarnation of the royal family and think like, oh, they're lovely people. You know what they've been doing really for the last 30 years? Damage control. You know where white supremacy comes from? The royal family. They're so white supremacist. They have their own church. Did y'all know that? There's the Church of England. There's not Lutheran. They're not Catholic. They're not Episcopalian. They're not Methodist. They're not Baptist. They have their own church. They literally created white supremacy. They invented and perfected the slave trade. They created the caste system that exists not just here, but also in India. They are not nice people. And the fact that they have getting cancer, Prince Charles has got the cancer, and so does the Kate Middleton, that's just karma. And cancer is a very bad thing. I don't want it. I don't want cancer even a little bit. I don't even want a taste of the cancers. Just saying. But how does somebody in this country become indoctrinated? I don't get it. I'm not understanding it. LT says if anyone was going to steal an election, they would have done it for Hillary Clinton because everybody hates her. And never let Donald Trump in the White House to begin with. You don't let somebody in and then kick them out. I don't think anybody would have stolen an election for Hillary Clinton for those reasons that you stated, LT. Nobody liked Hillary Clinton. I bet Bill Clinton didn't vote for Hillary. Hell no, I ain't voting for her. She ain't gave me none since I won my last election, governor of Arkansas.
Swallowed up. Have you ever been swallowed up?
Speaking of which, hello, Al.
Hey, how you doing? And that's going to happen when the IRS come here as well. Nothing going to be left untouched or left behind. But I heard you talk about saying we supposed to be free thinkers. See, I always thought we as black people supposed to be free thinkers. But some of our black people have been gaslighted into fantasy thinking. You know, when it comes to white supremacy, you know, that was one of the biggest thing of Christianity. You know, Christianity is the religion of sacrifice. I can't religion. You know, the religion of I can't be human. The religion that I have to jump through hoodles and do cartwheels and double sauce to go through hell just to get to heaven. But when you look at all these other groups, they getting their heaven now. They getting their 10,000 square foot homes, they 350,000 vehicles. They're getting all of it now. But for some reason, when it comes to some of our people, they feel it is anointing to be black and broke and dying for somebody who's going to have you building their mansion and cleaning their streets of gold in another place of yonder. And this is why I wanted to bring this up, because I heard people talk about they were praying. Let me let y'all people know, God do not care about political issues. He don't care about black people who've been suffering for 460 years. I thought God's supposed to be showing himself today. Come on now. God does not care about anything you do. He don't care about two men. He don't care about women bulldogging and dyking.
Hey!
Okay?
He might care about that. Maybe.
No, he don't. Can I share something with you, Mr. Hughes?
Please do.
Because he's supposed to be coming with a rapture. Hey! Why would he care about any of this nonsense on earth? But when black people was raped and tortured, hands pulled off and kids raped, he got the power to kick everybody out of heaven with the Christopher Columbus stuff. But when it comes to us as blacks, he has absolutely no power. Come on. Shaka laka boom, shaka laka yam yam pam pam bam bam wabba 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 bam bam. So what we need to do is focus on living and getting off this fantasy thinking, because if we don't, we will remain to be at the bottom of the barrel. So what I want to ask all you great individuals, since we are in our last days, because he's supposed to be showing himself today, get them yam-yams, them tam-tams, and bam-bams. Make sure you put that brown sugar and that butter all on them yam-yams, tam-tams, and bam-bams. Because he's supposed to be coming with his rapture today. Oh,
thank you, Al.
Have a good one.
Okay. Thank you. The Truth with Sherwin Hughes will be back for Hour 3.
Truth Nation, join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
1017 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to five Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on The Truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
Teachers are dynamic leaders, shaping a new generation. They bring a variety of perspectives from diverse backgrounds, innovating how they teach to prepare students for our fast-changing world. Achieving this takes skill and expertise. They're tireless explorers, creatively discovering a universe of solutions, telling stories, experimenting, inspiring, mentoring, connecting cultures, and connecting with each other. Leading by example. Experience the unique joy of helping students thrive. Teaching is a journey that shapes lives. Are you ready to begin? Explore teaching at teach.org, a campaign supported by the U.S. Department of Education, teach.org, and 1 million teachers of color.
If anyone knows the joy of rescuing animals, it's me. Just ask my rescues, who are all very important members of my family. Your life can also be forever changed by adopting a shelter pet. And it's not just about happiness your pet gets from finding a loving home, but that which you'll get from bringing them into your life. The heroes at American Humane have been helping animals for more than 140 years. Whether it's rescuing animals caught in disasters, ensuring the safety of animals' stars on screen, or protecting our planet's endangered species, they go above and beyond to further their mission and make the world a kinder place for animals. Please consider adopting a shelter pet and support American Humane. You can learn more at AmericanHumane.org.
Brought to you by American Humane.
Milwaukee's Black Talk lives here. You are listening to 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
It's The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Welcome to Hour 3 of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes. I was going to move on from the topic of how someone gets indoctrinated into a cult. Maybe it's a religious cult. Maybe it's a political one like we see here. I was going to move on. But whenever somebody speaks in tongues on this show, I feel like I need to stay with the topic just a little bit longer. It seems that there are a number of Donald Trump supporters. The reason why I'm talking about this is because this is right here in Wisconsin. And I would like to think that Wisconsin is not really a cult state. Florida is. Texas is. We don't do cults here. I don't even like when cultures, like in a particular place, become so uniform. Even racial culture. I know that there's black racial culture, which we've talked about a number of times, and we don't even really know what the hell black racial culture is. There's just like a handful of unwritten rules that black people are supposed to do, things we're supposed to do, music we're supposed to listen to, whatever, ways that we're supposed to think as black people, but it doesn't really work like that. But even in a workplace, I had an article, which I don't know if I'm going to get to it today. It talks about like certain workplaces that become almost cult-like, like coworkers call each other family. They're not your family, because if you get fired, ain't nobody buying you a Christmas present. But what's dangerous about when workplaces become cultish and become, there's like this cultural uniqueness to a workplace, then when people are indoctrinated into the cultural uniqueness of their workplace, like you do everything for the company, and I love this company, let me get a tattoo of the company's logo, this company saved my life, I love working here, I love my coworkers, yes, I'll work on the weekends, yes, I'll work extra shifts, yes, you don't have to pay me more money because I love it here so much. That's dangerous, because when someone becomes so indoctrinated into their workplace culture, they don't recognize discrimination because they overlook it. Or they make up an excuse for it. That's why it's very dangerous. You need to be ever vigilant, always being aware that there is someone trying to indoctrinate you into something. Maybe R. Kelly. Maybe he was a cult leader, the Pied Piper, which he called himself. He was indoctrinating people. And you know, that other guy. You know. No, not Bill Cosby. Bill Cosby wasn't with, his accusations weren't with young women. Them women were old. Maybe not in the 70s. But that he wasn't like going after children. He used Quaaludes. They don't make those anymore, by the way. What about Michael Jackson? To Michael Jackson, was he? What if Michael Jackson was a cult leader? And what if he used his music and his stardom and his celebrity to indoctrinate millions and millions of people? When I was in third grade, I got one of the best Christmas gifts ever. I got a Walkman, a portable Sony Walkman with an AM, FM radio and a cassette player. And I got a Michael Jackson Thriller tape. I was indoctrinated. Like, I didn't want Mike to touch me. I wasn't indoctrinated like that, but I liked Michael Jackson very much. He was everywhere. He was on the radio. He was on the music awards. We liked Michael Jackson very much. I bet if my parents met Michael Jackson way back in the day when he was at the height of his popularity, and he was so popular for so long, I don't even know what the height of Michael Jackson's popularity is. I think it was solidified for like 20 years until the accusations came. Then he became less popular. But I bet my parents, I bet Eugene and Emma would have let me go to Neverland. I bet Mike would have said to my parents, Eugene and Emma, Shimon, let me take Sherwin for the weekend and he can play with Bubbles. And my dad would be the first one to speak. Yeah, take the boy. It'll be good for him. Let him play with Bubbles. And then my mom, all right, that's fine. You can take him, Michael. I bet, because he was so popular. What if it takes someone with a real special talent, and that's how you become a cult leader, if you're really good at something? You know what was mesmerizing? I'm going to tell you what was mesmerizing, how Michael Jackson had many people. And he's just one example, because I'm over here searching and thinking of the ways in which someone, a clear thinking, free human being, an independent critical thinker, can become indoctrinated by someone and you become cult-like. It can be your boss. Some of your bosses are cult leaders because you love work so much. But you got to be careful at work, because then people will get so enthralled and so wrapped up into workplace culture and be so in love with the company and so in love with the mission that they fail to recognize workplace discrimination. You got to be forever vigilant when it comes to that. So just be careful when you're at work. Don't fall too deep into it. And a lot of y'all only fall deep into your workplace culture because they're paying you. Because a lot of y'all wouldn't work for who you work for free. Some of you would, though. But let me tell you what was very mesmerizing. When Michael Jackson did the moonwalk, I never seen anything like that before. There was an award ceremony. It must have been the, I don't know, what was the one where he did the moonwalk for the first time and people went nuts? And he didn't even invent the moonwalk. Some other black guy in the 40s invented it, but we didn't care about him. We only care when Michael Jackson did it. Michael Jackson wore penny loafers, glittery socks, and one glove. That's a cult leader. And he used his power to mesmerize children and parents, because the parents were in love with Michael Jackson too, to let your child stay with Michael Jackson. And you know what it is? Because prior to this particular documentary, I love documentaries because they can tell the unfiltered truth sometimes. There was the documentary called Leaving Neverland. I kind of wish I never watched it. Where do you find this stuff? That's amazing. It was on HBO some years ago. And I'm not the same after watching it. Because it's two grown men, they're grown men now, telling their stories about how they got to know Michael Jackson and how their families got to know Michael Jackson. Like, Michael Jackson would go to their house for dinner. It was the most unusual set of circumstances, and the parents, they thoroughly trusted Michael Jackson, and these two men telling their stories. And here's the thing. We often say, well, you got to believe victims. Believe them. When a woman comes forward, we have to believe her with no evidence, regardless of the situation. Now, I'm not getting into that argument with y'all, but when a woman comes forward, it takes a lot of courage to come forward to reveal sexual abuse or any other kind of abuse. We're supposed to stand with women and believe women. But what if it's men? Do we believe men at the same level that we believe women? Or is it because it's so much more common and frequent with women, and women are less likely to be believed because we still subjugate women even in the year 2024, that when women do have the courage to come forward, no matter what, we're supposed to believe them because of the courage that it takes? I would argue that it takes just as much courage for a man to come forward, because I don't want to say it's a common story, but a lot of women have been harassed or sexually abused. There's a lot of that. A lot. It's common. It happens a lot. Still happening right now. With men and with boys, it might be common too. But doesn't that make us look at those men differently if they come out and admit that they were sexually abused or harassed? Because we want to put it back on the men, like, oh, you weren't man enough to fight that person off. Well, not when it's Michael Jackson and he's rubbing you and caressing you with that sequined glove. He probably was very gentle with the glove, and he would remove it very slowly. One finger at a time. Michael Jackson would just remove that glove. One finger at a time. He'd slap you with it. It's not funny. How does someone get indoctrinated into a cult? Maybe Michael Jackson did it with a moonwalk. Maybe the moonwalk itself was hypnosis. I know I was trying to do the moonwalk. I can do a very good moonwalk right now. And I would do it right now on camera on the YouTube. But some of you may be indoctrinated, and I might be the new cult leader. Just saying, guys, trying to figure this out. Barbara Smith says, I remember being that 5-year-old scared to death I was going to burn in hell for eternity, because that is what they told me. It is absolutely 100,000% abusive. Zuri says, I remember being told that if I questioned things, I was disobedient and going to hell. Yes, can you imagine trying to take away a child's ability to think for themselves by scaring them to death? That is so abusive. I don't think that I was threatened with hell. Threats didn't really work against me as a child. You know, people tried. My parents tried. They would just, like, take stuff away from me. Can't use a phone. Can't watch TV, like that kind of stuff. That worked better than like threatening to do stuff, because they would threaten me often. I'd be like, yeah, we'll see. Yeah, sure. That didn't work, as you can tell, because I'm basically just an adult version of who I was as a child. Just now, I can do whatever I want. But as a child, you couldn't really do whatever you want. Like now I can stay out all night. As a child, I couldn't do that. So now I'm basically the same person. I question authority because we should. I question people's motives and their intentions. I'm a critical thinker. I always have been. I was the child that asked a lot of questions. I was very inquisitive. I had many questions. All I needed as a child was the internet, and I would have been fine. Because, you know, back in the day, we didn't have access to information like we do now. Now we have all the access to all of the information ever written, ever recorded. All of it is right there. And it seems like we are dumber than ever. You don't believe me? Look at some of the conspiracy theories surrounding the eclipse, which we are, I don't know, 3 hours away from totality. 2 hours. No, three. Just under 3 hours, right? 2:08 p.m. here in Milwaukee. I'm going to be out there. I got a location already designated, and I picked this location. I'm not telling you where it is. I don't need none of y'all out there ruining my eclipse viewing. I know where it is. Here's the problem, though. It's in a public place, but of all the places that were mentioned in southeastern Wisconsin, especially in Milwaukee County, to view the eclipse, this place wasn't mentioned, and I like that. And it's relatively close to my house. So I'm going to go there. First, I'm going to get my glasses. They have them at, somebody said Meijer, but then they said they couldn't confirm they were at Meijer. I'm going to the public museum downtown, only a few blocks away from where we are at the American Family Insurance Studio here at the 3rd Street Market Hall. I'm going to get my glasses. Might get an extra pair because I might run into Liz Brown, who's just going to be staring at the sun. I want to protect Liz Brown. Protect Liz Brown! Liz hates my guts, by the way. She just, I don't know why. Did I ever tell y'all the story about the first Juneteenth day with Liz Brown and Tory? I'm not telling that story again. It's not like I made the story up. We had vehicles. This is before we have our own vehicle now. We have a truth vehicle. But the first Juneteenth day, because we started as a radio station in January of 2021. January 4th, 2021 was our first broadcast day. So that June, 6 months later, it was the first Juneteenth day that 1017 The Truth as a radio station was a part of. So Good Karma Brands rented us a bunch of Jeeps, Jeep Wrangler convertibles, and they were driven by salespeople of the dealership that we borrowed the Jeeps from. Okay, so we line up in the Juneteenth Day Parade. And those of you that have ever been in the Juneteenth Day Parade, like, that's the party. The lineup, all seeing all those black people, people you haven't seen since last Juneteenth Day, it's phenomenal. It's magical. And they say that black people don't love each other. Come to a Juneteenth Day right before the parade starts. There's nothing like it on earth, I promise. So we're lining up, and we're in the Jeep. And we have these, our names are on magnets on the Jeep. So it's me and Tory Lowe in a Jeep. Perfect target for an assassin. They could have sniped us. You got me and Tory Lowe in the same vehicle? That's like sniping both Kennedys. So Liz Brown came as well. And so Tory, being the man of the people that he is, he was going to sit on the hood of the Jeep while we were in the parade. And the sales manager, whoever the guy was that was driving the Jeep from whatever dealership, was like, hey, Tory, because of the insurance we have to have on these vehicles, you have to sit in the vehicle. You can't sit on the hood. Tory looked at him like he was short. Tory looked him up and down. Tory's like, I'm going to sit on the hood. And the guy was very nice. He was like, no, Tory, you actually have to sit in the vehicle because if something happens, if you fall off, if you get hurt, a whole bunch of liability. Our insurance does not allow people to sit on the vehicle for using it for a parade. And Tory was like, well, then I guess we're not going nowhere then. And here comes Liz. So now Tory is sitting on the hood of the Jeep in front of the driver. Liz comes and sits on the hood of the Jeep in front of me because I'm in the passenger seat. And that's just what it was. And so because now the parade is starting to move. We're starting to move. And then the person from the dealership that was in charge of driving the Jeep just had no choice. And so that first Juneteenth day, nobody even really could see me because on the front of the vehicle, outside the vehicle, was Tory Lowe sitting on the hood on the driver's side and then Liz Brown sitting on the hood on a passenger side. And that was my first Juneteenth day with the truth. And so me being in the passenger seat, as I'm looking out the window, all I saw was ass. Tories and Liz's. For 2 hours of a parade. Pow! You are listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, it's Telly Hughes from Truth Be Told with Denise Thomas and Telly Hughes, and I have to let you know that the best morning show in the country is streaming live on YouTube every weekday from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Yes, DT and I are now waking you up in the a.m. live every weekday on YouTube. So go to YouTube right now to subscribe to 101.7 The Truth so you can watch Denise and I get your morning started off right. Milwaukee Black Talk is now streaming live on YouTube.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Hey, Milwaukee, my name is Martina, and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
Introducing your trusted partner for all your freight transportation needs, it is Out the Mud Hauling. From local to long distance hauls, they ensure seamless, timely deliveries for businesses nationwide. They offer a variety of services like cross docking, order fulfillment, debris removal, hazardous material handling, pallet storage, and much more. Whether you're a seasoned shipper or an aspiring entrepreneur, trust Out the Mud Hauling for all your trucking needs across the USA. Contact them today at 262-278-1595. Out the Mud Hauling.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
I'm taking a tour of a school tomorrow. I don't know if I'm supposed to tell y'all that. But I was made aware of conditions in a particular MPS school, not going to say which one, not going to say where, that are really bad. And so I want to see for myself. So I'll keep you posted on that. Got a feeling they're all of a sudden probably going to cancel my visit. But we talk about education a lot, especially because there was a referendum that was just passed, not by a lot of votes. So it is incumbent upon me and those of us that care about education and the state of education, which I do. I'm not just here bashing the Milwaukee public school system, but I think it does leave a lot to be desired considering the amount of money that we're investing in it. And most people who know anything about investing, if you put an investment in, whether it be time, resources, money, you want to see something in return. Now, there's some wonderful people, wonderful, very smart people, intelligent people that come from Milwaukee public schools, but there's not enough. And there's a formula for how schools can work well and be very high performing, even when y'all say the parents are not involved. Because can we be honest, a lot of our parents weren't involved. I didn't ask my parents for homework help. That's pointless. I mean, I asked Emma a couple of times. I don't know what this is. Emma wasn't no good. I was better off calling one of my classmates and getting help with my homework than asking either of my parents because they didn't care, which is actually fine. Because my pursuit of scholarship and academia was very much a personal kind of pursuit. Now, there may have been a question or something. I never was really good with word problems. I'm not good at those. I never really have been. I'm probably better now than I was then, but they ain't really my cup of tea. I might have asked my parents about a word problem, but other than that, didn't really ask them. But there is a formula because other cities have done it. And Milwaukee is not some unusual outlier. There are a lot of cities that have large African-American public school populations that were doing very poorly, and they were underfunded as well, and they had a bad funding flaw, but they were able to take some of those schools that were as underperforming or even worse than the Milwaukee Public School and turn them around, and now they are churning out Black graduates at a very high level that are going on to college or trade school. They are preparing young Black folks for a world of work or learning right out of high school. But for some reason, we can't do that here. And then they keep asking for money. And those of us that want to see the children successful, or there are some of you that are willing to have your property taxes go up to ensure that MPS remains a failure. I'm not sure which ones voted for the referendum. I think it was a combination of both. Some that have some guilt, because it was a majority white people with no kids that voted for the $250 million property tax increase for the Milwaukee public school system. That's very unusual. I know the whites. And they in turn know me. If they are voting to increase the amount that they are paying for property taxes, and in certain designated segregated parts of the city, there are white people that are paying $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 a year for property taxes. That's a lot of money. And if your, what's the math on this? Property taxes are going up $216 per $100,000 of assessed value. That means for $1 million property, a house or a condo, your property taxes are going up $2,616 a year. That's not how much they are. That's how much they're going to increase. Now, wouldn't you think, because the white folks know the investing very well, they do, and they know that if they're going to pay more for something, they want to get more in return than they are putting in. Doesn't that make sense? If they know that there's going to be $250 million invested into the Milwaukee public school system, wouldn't you think that there would be an incredible influx of Caucasian people saying, well, now that MPS is going to be so well funded, this is where I want to send my children? But they're not going to do that. Why would you pay for something? This is defying me, just like trying to figure out how somebody can be indoctrinated into the cult. Unless you use the moonwalk. The moonwalk will indoctrinate someone, because when Michael Jackson did it, some of y'all were just like, oh, that's what you said. That's exactly the sound you made. I bet there's other reasons why people can make that sound as well.
What do you mean by that?
You know exactly what I mean. So if they're going to be paying more money to increase the funding of the schools, how come they don't want to send their kids to the school? Because if I found out a school district got $250 million worth of money, then you're going to, oh, it's going to be perfect. It's going to be a small student-to-teacher ratio. It's going to be all the technology. You're going to have the best teachers. You're going to have all the things. But for some reason, that is not happening. It's also perplexing to me that the majority of the people that voted yes, because we can look at this heat map of the yes votes versus the no votes. There's a lot of data that is not coming up about who voted for that referendum, but it's white people with no kids. Do y'all really feel that sorry for Black children? Because I can't tell. Are these, remember the George Floyd whites? Remember them? Oh my God, they used to hold the door open for us. Remember in the days of George Floyd, how nice white people were? I remember going to a first restaurant I went to was Jose's Blue Sombrero in Wauwatosa. Food sucks, by the way. Terrible. Terrible Mexican food. Sorry. That's my personal opinion. I stand on it. It's awful food. But it was open. This was in May of 2020, because the suburbs around here, outside of the city of Milwaukee, they gave zero Fs about COVID. They're like, COVID schmovid, we're open for business. So I went to Jose's Blue Sombrero, and I was meeting some friends there because we hadn't gone out to eat in months. But I'm walking, because it's on State Street. So I'm like 70, I don't know, 73rd and State, Jose's Blue Sombrero, the home of disgusting Mexican food. And I remember I'm approaching the crosswalk, and there was a car, someone in the distance. Somewhat. I'm just walking up to the crosswalk, and this car, there's a white fella in it, he had glasses on, and he stopped so I could cross the street. And he stopped like way too early. He waved me. He's like, no, go ahead. I think he only did that because he felt George Floyd's sympathy. Wait a minute. I don't think George Floyd was dead yet. May 25th, right? No, that was probably about the time. It was shortly after the George Floyd death. That makes sense. The end of May. It was Memorial Day weekend, right? That Friday? When the white people were very nice to us, they'd hold the door open for us. They'd say please and thank you. But then all of a sudden, the Black Lives Matter signs that people would have in their windows. Remember, they even had yard signs like Black Lives Matter was something you could vote for. They had them all in the yard, all in the suburbs. Or did they do that because they didn't want their houses to be looted? Can white people be honest with me? Just for a little while, they can go back to lying. It's perfectly fine. We're used to it. Did you put Black Lives Matter signs in the windows of your homes and your businesses so that protesting black people didn't break your windows? Because I think that was part of the case. You put the sign up like, oh, no, don't hurt us. We're with you. There was it's like a cafe. It's on 91st and Center. You know what I'm talking about? It is on the southwest corner of 91st and Center. There's a school, it's an elementary school, right across the street, and it's a cafe. And they had all their windows busted out. All of them. They had plywood up because all the windows, they must have been on the route of a major violent protest because all their windows were broken out and they had plywood up. Either the windows were broken out or they put the plywood up so the windows didn't get broken out. But I remember it saying on the plywood, like, black people welcome, Black Lives Matter on the plywood. And I wonder if they did that. Was it sincere? Because I'm wondering where those white people are now because they're supposed to help us fight the racism. Or was it just to look like you were outraged like we were? I'm not sure. What else do I got here? Should I talk about education? How about we do that? I'm going to talk about education when we come back. Public K-12 schools in the United States face a host of challenges these days, from teacher shortages to the lingering effects of COVID-19, learning loss to political battles over curriculum. Yeah, we'll talk about that on the other side. You're listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't just trust anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and has been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Schedule your free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit BubonOrtho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, a family treating families.
At UW Credit Union, our home loans have everything you need for your next big step, including up to $750 off closing costs for all home buyers. And first-time buyers can save even more. So if you're ready to trade roomies for more room or your town home for an out-of-town home, UW Credit Union will be with you from start to furnished. UW Credit Union. Apply online today. Equal housing lender. Credit may be limited as required by program. Visit uwcu.org for details.
It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 101.7 The Truth. Here is Dr. Ken Harris with his truth.
Take this new year and consider changing how you tackle issues and problems. You know, a new year is an opportunity to see the world, well, actually your world, in a new way. not in the I'm going to start a new exercise or a new job or a new way of life kind of way. It's a time to see the world and I'm going to change the way I process my life and surroundings kind of way. Politics, religion, family, work, taxes, all that. It's all changing this year with counties, cities, state, federal, all these elections coming. With the separation of church and state being redefined, and with the canceling of the American mind well in hand, there's not a lot left to be grateful for except how you see the world and understand the world. So I got three quick suggestions. Number one, take off the rose-colored glasses and see the world for what it is. Second, choose information from sources and a place of balance, so that it's not all one way or another way or just feeds what you already understand and know. Lastly, challenge yourself this year with a new, higher level of knowledge. In 2024, remember, it's about having your perception elevated. You might know it as hope.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 1017 The Truth. Listen to The Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris, weekdays from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. It's The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, it's a big week for First Stage. A classic book series is coming to a live stage near you. Diary of a Wimpy Kid musical is coming to life at the Children's First Stage Theater in downtown Milwaukee. Bring the whole family to see this classic book turned into a musical by visiting firststage.com. The show runs at the Marcus Performing Arts Center from April 6th through May 5th. Get your tickets today to see the Diary of a Wimpy Kid musical by visiting firststage.com for tickets. And baseball season is finally here, and we want to celebrate the Milwaukee Brewers with you, Truth Nation. From now through the end of April, we will be giving away tickets to cheer on the Brewers live from American Family Field. For your chance to win a pair of tickets to a game, you must download the 1017 The Truth app and be on lookout for our weekly notifications. Play ball with the truth and go watch the Brew Crew by downloading the 1017 The Truth app today. We'll download the app, and then I guess the Brewers are doing good. They're winning the baseball games. The Bucks are not winning. The Bucks would have lost to the South Carolina ladies, the South Carolina Gamecocks. I did a little bit of coverage on the ladies' basketball. A mainstream media outlet, I'm not going to tell you which one, I'm going to let you find it on your own, said the Gamecocks beat off Iowa's challenge. I just found the wording interesting. No, it was not me. I didn't make that up. I wouldn't have said that. So my ex-girlfriend, God knows I got a bunch of those. Her son went to South Carolina. He was a Gamecock. And she was a Gamecock mom. And so she had a lot of like hats and T-shirts because that's where her son went to college. And she had this one shirt, and it was a women's T-shirt, which she wore, is probably a size too small. And she was chesty. That's just her body type. She was very chesty. And so she had a whole bunch of like T-shirts, and hats from the school that her son attended college. He has since graduated. South Carolina Gamecocks, the Lady Gamecocks. Well, you would think it'd be the Lady Game Hens, because the cock is a male chicken, a rooster. I know I'm skating on thin ice by talking about this. So she had this one particular shirt. I don't know if I should say this. Am I going to get censored if I say, because it's the mascot is the Gamecocks, okay? But on the shirt, it just said Cox. And it was across her breasts in the T-shirt. So when you saw her wearing the T-shirt, and I said, please don't wear that T-shirt. She's like, why not? It's the mascot of where my son goes to college. It just gave off the wrong impression. So congratulations to the Lady Gamecocks for beating Iowa and Caitlin Clark, who apparently is a good basketball person. I personally think I could beat her in a game of one-on-one, but whatever. Public K-12 schools in the United States faced a host of challenges these days, from teacher shortages to the lingering effects of COVID-19 learning loss to political battles over curriculum. In the midst of all of this, teachers express low levels of satisfaction with their jobs. In fact, they are much less satisfied than U.S. workers overall. Here's how public K through 12 teachers are feeling about their jobs. 77% say their job is frequently stressful. Well, of course it is. Children are, in some cases, terrible. Can we admit that? If I walk into a place and it's a bunch of children, other than a school where children are supposed to be, I immediately want to turn around and walk out. There is a girl I dated many years ago. Of course, she's an ex. She actually got married. She had two kids, which that was plenty for me. So we dated. It didn't work out. She then got married, had another kid, and is divorced again. But whatever, it's fine. I made the mistake. Why would I do this? Fellas, the mistakes that we make following behind a woman, I swear. So she said, hey, I'm taking the kids to Chuck E. Cheese. You want to come with me? I didn't want to go. But I knew to make nice with her, I had to go to Chuck E. Cheese. Is the Chuck E. Cheese in Brookfield on Blue Mound still open? Because this was many, many years ago. This was like in 06 or 07. I think it was a war zone back then.
Are there any Chuck E. Cheese still open?
I hope not. Because the adults get drunk and fight at Chuck E. Cheese. And so I'm reading this statistic that says 77% of teachers are stressed out because of their jobs because of your kids. Your kids act different when you're not around. Okay? So anyways, I go to Chuck E. Cheese with this woman that I'm dating at the time. And we take her two sons. And her sons at the time were, I think the youngest boy was 2 or 3 years old. And the oldest boy was like 5 or 6. And I didn't want to have anything to do with them. So she was like, oh, don't worry, I'm going to watch them. You just sit down and order the pizza. And I'll come back and hang out with you for a little bit. But I'm going to let my sons play games. I'm like, cool. And everything was fine. And I'm seeing all these motherless and fatherless little rapscallion children, little cave children running around acting like they ain't got no sense. Somebody is crying. Something is getting spilled over here. Somebody's always having a birthday party. So you got cake, you got pizza, you got kids running around all over the place. That's the Chuck E. Cheese on Blue Mountain. Don't even know if it's still open. I know it's a war zone. I heard about that Chuck E. Cheese a couple of times on the news, not because the kids were fighting, but the damn adults are fighting. So this is where the kids get from. Oh, there you go. That sounded powerful, like Tori Lowe says. Everything was fine until it was time to go. The oldest boy, he was cool. The youngest boy decided he wanted to run and hide. And then, because the mother is running, I can't chase this child. I got a reputation to uphold. I'm going to chase another woman's child. It's your child. You had it. I didn't have that child. That child came here before you and I met. So she's chasing the child around to Chuck E. Cheese, and then when she finally catches him, what does he do? He lays out in the floor and starts screaming and crying like he's being abused. At this point, I'm panicking, so I walk out the door because I don't want to be witness to what is happening because now everybody's looking. I was a grown-ass man, but that's fine. And so this two-year-old child is laying in the middle of the floor of Chuck E. Cheese, screaming and crying and having a fit because he doesn't want to leave the Chuck E. Cheese. That was the last time I went to a Chuck E. Cheese, and I was probably in 2007. So that boy who was 2 years old then is, if you were two in 07, you were born in 05, he's 19 now. He's a grown-ass man. He might even have his own kids by this point in time. Oh, that was him crying. That was the audio of him crying. I know that his mother used to listen to the show because she reached out to me after she got divorced. She was married once. I met her after that divorce. She had two kids with that husband. She and I dated for, we actually dated for a little bit. It was a little while, a couple years probably. And then she and I parted ways, and then she met another guy, married him, had a daughter, because she wanted a daughter. She had two sons. She wanted a daughter. She tried to approach me with that nonsense. Sherwin, don't you want to have a baby with me? No, not even a little bit. No part of me. And no offense, but if a man is upfront with you and says, hey, I don't want to make another person with you, that's him being respectful instead of him just going along. Oh, yeah, baby, I'll have a child with you. Duh. That's stupid. Because when the baby comes, you can't put it back. I mean, you can give it away, I guess. Did you know you can take a baby to, like, a fire station, no questions asked? Did you know that? That it's legal? There's, a law that if a woman has a baby, or a man, a birthing person has a baby, and you decide, not for me. It cries. You got to feed it or whatever. And you decide it's not for you. You can give your baby to a fireman. You can bring it to a fire station, and they don't even ask any questions. You'd think that they would ask for some paperwork, right? If you just drop off a baby, don't you want to have, like, receipts and stuff for it? I don't know how that works. I'm trying not to be offensive, but I know some parents get very overwhelmed, and the lady doesn't want the baby, which is her right. There's the adoption route, which is her right again. But you can also just take a baby to a fire station and just be like, this didn't work out. We don't get along so good. And you can just drop off the baby. But we would rather that happen than someone else do something with the baby. You know, you don't want them to, like, auction it off or anything. So you just take it to a fire station and just give it to a fireman or whatever. 68% of teachers say their job is overwhelming. 70% say their school is understaffed. And here's the kicker. 52% of public K through 12 teachers say they would not advise a young person starting out today to become a teacher. Pause there and pick it back up on the other side. You are listening to The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 101.7 FM. I'll be right back.
More of The Truth with Sherwin Hughes is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Dr. Ken Harris here, and I'm excited about The Truth's partnership with Versity. There is a serious need for blood donations in the Black community, and Versity wants to bring awareness to this because it's their mission to improve patient outcomes, advance the field of personalized medicine, and strengthen the health of communities everywhere. This is why you should tune in every month when a representative from Versity joins The Truth to share about what they're doing to make a difference in our community.
This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Justice is about receiving what we deserve. Quote Audre Lorde, who said, there is no such thing as a single issue struggle because we do not live single issue lives. And that said, any freedom, including reproductive freedom, is our human right to decide what is best for our own lives. Reproductive freedom is about having bodily autonomy, which is the same as being able to control what happens to our bodies, including the decision to continue or terminate a pregnancy, rest with the pregnant person at all times and in all circumstances. Because when rights don't apply to all individuals and at all times, they are not rights. They are not rights. And as Black people, our rights are conditional way too often, whether we're talking about during police encounters, quality housing, or, you know, some job opportunity.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Experience, knowledge, results. That's what really matters when you need help after a serious truck accident. You'll need a lawyer experienced in fighting and winning for people just like you. Gruber Law Offices has the resources, strong track record of success, and a team of experienced lawyers to take care of your needs. We've successfully helped people injured in big truck accidents for more than 35 years. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Hey, Milwaukee, my name is Martina, and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
This is The Truth with Sherwin Hughes on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
April is Financial Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered on learning about how you can best manage your money. All April, we will speak with representatives from Educators Credit Union to discuss financial strategies and tools they offer to their members to help enhance your financial management skills. Financial Literacy Month on the award-winning 1017 The Truth is sponsored by Educators Credit Union, achieving more together. And Truth Nation, we're excited for the official launch of Jamming with Juice this Thursday at 6 p.m. Jamming with Juice is a Truth-exclusive YouTube series hosted by our very own Kerry Noni and Benjamin himself. So make sure you are tapped in by subscribing to 1017 The Truth on YouTube so you don't miss the debut of Jamming with Juice this Thursday at 6 p.m. Milwaukee Black Talk just keeps getting better. And Wednesday, tune in at 6 p.m. for the Thanalysis podcast and the award-winning 1017 The Truth. Thanasis Antetokounmpo will be joined by Duke basketball legend Jay Williams and Bucks guard Malik Beasley. They will have a real conversation about life as well as deep dives into the NBA world. Do not miss the Thanalysis podcast on The Truth Wednesday night at 6 p.m. on the 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk. What's this one? All right, that's all for today. It for today's announcements. Now let's talk to Marlon. You're on 1017 The Truth. How are you?
Good. And yourself?
I'm doing well, sir. What's going on? Are you going to watch the eclipse, Marlon?
So I'll probably step outside and check it out real quick.
All right.
I mean, it's something that doesn't come around that often, so I'll check it out. But I'm not going crazy over it, so yeah.
Okay.
A quick question. So I've been following this case where they found the human leg down in South Milwaukee on a beach. Then they found some other parts in a park here in Milwaukee, and then they raided two or three different houses. And is it weird to you because the way they're making it seem like this ain't the same person who's been cut up? Because if it is, then we're dealing with a serial killer. And if it's just a weird situation. Do you agree with that or no?
So personally, I think it's the same person, a very deranged and demented individual that's putting the public and the local authorities on a scavenger hunt, which is disgusting. But remember, we're also the city that had Jeffrey Dahmer. So those people actually are out there.
Yeah.
But because they haven't done any verified DNA testing, they don't know who the parts belong to. Now, there is a woman who has been reported missing, and her vehicle was found in the area that one of the parts was also found. I'm not making that correlation. I'm hoping that woman is alive and well, but I am personally under the impression that it is the same individual. If it is several individuals, then yes, we do have a serial killer on our hands.
I agree with you 100%. I thought it was the same person as well, but of course they got to be kind of impartial, so they kind of say certain things. But they're making it seem like it's a bunch of different people. So I was just wondering what you thought, because I don't know why I find it very interesting, and I'm following it pretty closely and being kind of trying to find different stuff. So yes, sir. So I appreciate it though.
Thank you, Marlon. Appreciate your call.
Thank you.
All right. You know, one of our listeners only has one leg. Her name is Lisa. Might be Lisa's leg. I don't know. Well, and the other thing that would tell us, and I don't know what body parts they have found. They did talk about a leg that was found in Cudahy, near Warnemount Park in Cudahy. So I got a very good friend that lives in Cudahy. So I'm on a group text with him. Now, I wasn't going to say nothing. But the other person on the group text was like, yo, they found a leg by your house. You know anything about that? And it's not funny. But if they found like two left legs, well, that obviously, that's two different people, right? Because you can tell a left leg from a right leg. There was a huge police presence on Sunday, April 7th, near 31st and Walnut in Milwaukee. Police confirmed on Monday, April 8th, that a, quote, unidentified human remains were located in the area. The news comes after Milwaukee police discovered a human body part. See, they're not even saying which part it is. They discovered an unidentified human remain on Saturday near the West Side neighborhood. The Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office told Fox 6 that investigators, along with the Milwaukee Police Department, were called to the area of 30th and Lisbon after the body part was found around 10 p.m. on Friday. Investigators have not said exactly where the body part was found or what body part it was. Let's talk. Oh, jeez. This will be a doozy. Hello. How can I help you? Hello.
Hello.
Hey there.
What's going on? Want a quick question. You know what I'm saying? And I'm glad, you know what I'm saying, every time I talk to you, you know what I'm saying, you be real nice to talk to me and shit like that. I can hear it all in your voice. But anyway.
You can't cuss.
NPS.
Can't say the S word. Don't you know that by now?
NPS. Hey, let me ask a question because I know time running out. NPS, okay, they won, they got their money. What can the public do to hold their feet to the fire to make sure they're going to do what they're going to do with the money? Like, can we put an audit out on them? Can we, is it some way we can look at the numbers or whatnot like that? How can we do that going forward? Because they're going to ask for some money again, you know what I'm saying? And what up with that that building idea that you always be talking about regarding the NPS?
So the public can start by being much more engaged by attending public school board meetings. And I think that the next board meeting is at the end of the month. If you go to the
MPA. You asked me, I'm glad you said that. Because last time I talked to you about that, you said, hey, go to the MPS school meeting. I know that because it was the day before my birthday. Uh-huh. I was going to go down there and then they canceled it. What up with that?
That was a town hall meeting that was scheduled by a single school board director. This was not a full public meeting of the board. They didn't cancel it. They just had to move the location. The meeting still went on. It was supposed to be at Washington High School, but they moved it to the Black Historical Society. So it wasn't canceled, but that wasn't a full board meeting. What the public can do is start getting familiar with board governance and attending those monthly school board meetings, because once you attend, then you can figure out where else and how best you can be involved with the administration of those funds.
I just say that because this stuff been going on for like 25 years, how these NPS been going down. You know what I'm saying? And it's like they act like, nobody's going to do anything about it, so we'll do what we want. You know what I'm saying? We got to find a way to get them people out of there and get some fresh people in there, particularly at the top. That's my opinion. That's my time. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Calls with him can go one of two ways. That actually was not a bad one. So that one went the good way. So that his name is The Town. Well, that's what he goes by when he calls the radio station. I don't believe that's on his birth certificate. So we had three referenda questions on our most recent ballot on April 2nd. And two of them involved changing the Wisconsin state constitution to reflect this Trump-like paranoia that our elections are being taken over by outside forces. Everyone should have just voted no on those referenda. And I read the questions. I can't tell you how many times. I got a legal analysis from several different lawyers. I even read breakdowns on several shows. I dedicated like a week, if not two, to those very complicated referendum questions. First and foremost, I read them several times over because the first time I read them, I didn't understand them one bit. And y'all remember that. I had to read them several times for it to make any kind of sense because they write referendum questions in a confusing manner. It's like yes is no and no is yes. Very confusing, okay? And so I did my level best to try and explain to people what voting yes means versus voting no. So that person that just called, okay?
voted probably yes. I even made up rhymes because all three referendum questions, if you were a decent, fair individual, you should have voted no on all three, including the NPS referendum. So I even made up rhymes. Vote no on all three in my country, tis of thee, or vote no on the referendums. And then whatever, I just said a bunch of stuff that made it easy for you to remember to vote no on all three. So the two constitutional amendment referendums passed. And even people that listened to this program said, oh, sure, when I voted yes, because I thought I was supposed to vote yes. That person got mad at me because he thinks that I didn't explain it well enough for him to understand he should have voted no. And the only reason why I'm bringing this up is because I heard that person that just called call another show and complain about me not explaining better to him why he should have voted no. Thank you guys for listening. That's my time. Have a wonderful day and wear sunglasses when you look at the eclipse. I'll see you next time.
It's Dr. Ken Harris, and you can watch me now live on YouTube every weekday from 4 to 6 p.m., and you can watch the best radio show in Wisconsin by going to 1017 The Truth on YouTube. Watch me explore the issues which are shaping our community while also having fun discussions, pop culture, current events, all kind of stuff going on right here on YouTube right now by subscribing to 1017 The Truth. Milwaukee Black Talk is now streaming live on YouTube.
Truth Nation, tune in Wednesday night at 6 p.m. for the Thanalysis podcast and the award-winning 1017 The Truth. Thanalysis will be joined by Duke basketball legend Jay Williams and Bucks guard Malik Beasley. They will have a real conversation about life as well as deep dives of the NBA world. Do not miss the Thanalysis podcast on The Truth Wednesday night at 6 p.m. on 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
Severe flooding from recent hurricanes and other storms has left hundreds of thousands of cars, trucks, and other vehicles unsafe to drive. Flooded vehicles are supposed to be dismantled for usable parts or crushed for scrap, and a flood title should be issued to that car. But some shady dealers will buy a flooded vehicle, clean it up,